I believe we're streaming. I realize as soon as I hit the streaming button that I don't have the stream open, so that means I don't have the chat open.
You're going hyper focus. You don't need them.
I'm going hyper focus.
Oh yeah, chat's holding you back.
Chat, yeah. I didn't say that, chat. I did not say that.
Oh, live. Well, hey, everyone.
Hello, everybody. Okay, it looks like we are streaming. We can see both of us. We can hear both of us. Time to put my mouth where my money is. Absolutely. I love Dark Souls. I'm a big.
Put your mouth where your money is. Where do you keep your wallet?
That's a question for all of us. Where do you keep your wallet? In a perfect world, my wallet is not in my pants at all. It is in some sort of bag. I do not like it, having a wallet on my person.
There you go. I've got a decoy wallet, and then ideally, well, right now, I leave my wallet in the car because my girlfriend drives around more, and I was like, I'm paranoid that she's going to be trapped somewhere without money.
Yeah,
keep my wallet there for her.
Yeah, no, that's fair. That's fair. I have a wallet. I just don't like sitting perhaps on it. I don't like it in my front in pockets. Dream. I don't like it. You know, I just don't. I don't like a wallet.
I don't like it. Do you think they could innovate on the wallet design? Is that what throws you off?
Every once in a while, like I have an iPhone. Every once in a while, I'll use like Apple Pay, and it blows my mind. Where it's just like my phone has my credit card information, and I tap it against a thing, and I don't have to deal with anything. I love that.
Hands off, he says. You believe in technology? You got some people saying that your volume is a little
my
low.
Volume is a little low. You're looking. Okay, now I've turned my volume up. Let's see here. I'm in the yellow. And where are you, Frost?
I'm not sure what they're. They didn't say anything.
You're in the yellow now.
Okay, and now we're good.
Can you hear game? Can you hear me rolling through the grass in the game? It shouldn't be terribly loud, but you should hear it.
That's good, yeah. Sounds good, bounces better. Nice, yeah. And for those of you wondering, Nick did not run off screaming to Iceland to avoid the game. He's on a business trip thing.
He's on the business trip. Yes, Nick is on a business trip to Iceland. Are we able to say why he's on a business trip to Iceland? Or
I don't know, Jack. I don't keep up with Bargos. So
with Bargos.
Yeah. We're gonna Bargo bust today. I don't know. We'll let Nick tell you. He'll probably show up at some point or other. I just scream for Marty. Hail.
How do you spell Timothy? I want to be a Timothy.
It starts with a J, a silent J.
Okay.
Yeah, and then T-I. Yeah. Oh, shoot. Which one are you going for? M-M-O-T-H-E-E or like T-I-M-O-T?
Ooh, Je Timothy. I love it. Great.
Je Timothy, Je Timothy Chalamet.
I did recall my name. There we go. I am Je Timothy. At least you know your own name. What I'm thinking here is, to be fun, we are going to choose the deprived.
Right.
I don't know what the good gifts are here. Bonfire aesthetic, seed of the tree times, homework. Ooh, healing wares. That could be fun.
You're just nudist. Yeah, naked man run.
Yeah, the old naked man run. That's good. And then we'll go to body. I'm thinking, that's good. Got to be a big dude.
Yep, huge.
Big muscle dude. Love that. Let's go to face.
The only
thing I want is a mustache. That's all I really want.
The only thing you wear. You just made Escanor from Seven Deadly Sins. All right.
I don't know what that is.
He's a big, beefy guy that looks just like this.
Okay.
Only a mustache. Yeah, I'm sure chat, you'll know. You'll recognize him.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Oh, my God. Yeah, I'm with Old Hunter. The other day, I was buying lunch at a falafel place. Their digital payment machine froze. I felt like a sorcerer wielding the ancient power of cash.
Who has cash?
Me, because I'm paranoid of the taco trucks of their their little credit card thing dying on them. So I was like, here you go. Got cash. I have a lot of food trucks around me.
You know, that's fair. That's fair.
All people come here for the same reason.
I'm going to tell you that that's fair. Every once in a while when I do like have cash on me, I feel very special. I feel like, ooh, you know, I'm going to give my tip in cash instead of putting tip on the credit card just to be saucy, just to be extra special.
And then they're like, why would he do this to me? I have to carry this.
Like using my phone, but my wrist wallet. Wrist wallet? What's a wrist wallet?
Like on a Apple Watch?
Oh, sure. Yeah, if you use your Apple Watch for payment.
I suppose. Yeah.
I have an Apple Watch. I never use it for payments.
I'm paranoid of that. Like, I'll roll over in my sleep and buy big waifu body pillow type things.
Sure.
Yeah, because I wake up and I have like game apps on my phone. I don't recall downloading. I can only imagine I was rolling.
That's not how it works, right? All right. So one thing I learned after Nick started playing, I picked up Dark Souls 2 just for shits and giggles.
All right.
Just to see, like, how fast I could do things and, you know, optimal paths, that sort of fun stuff. And something I learned that I think is unique amongst Dark Souls 2, among the many things that are unique amongst Dark Souls 2, is that the Deprived does not have a starting weapon.
Oh?
In other Dark Souls games, the Deprived gets a club to start with.
Right. Yeah.
Oh, I thought he gave me a dagger. Does one of you give me a dagger?
So you're going to fish for a weapon here, then?
Yeah. So we need a weapon. Oh, there it is. Okay.
Yeah.
So there's a dagger. There's a dagger up here. And...
there you go.
Oh, I don't... and now I don't know where I'm going anymore. Oh, here it is. Here it is. Everything's fine. I found it.
There we go. And then this is your most played Souls game?
No, probably... probably Elden Ring at this point.
Well, what about of the three? Dark Souls 1, 2, 3.
Of the three, maybe I've played one the most.
Okay.
But I truly... oh, crap. I have made a terrible mistake here, Frost, by not killing anybody.
Yeah, all right. Well, gotcha. I am keeping track of kills. No pressure.
Oh, I didn't know that. And I didn't equip any of my... healing items.
we get the first one out of the way. I think Nick fell off a cliff on his first one.
Oh, good.
I assume this is the Scholar of the First Sin version? I'd imagine so.
This is. It's the only version I have, which is the Scholar of the First Sin edition. Okay. All right, let's get a dagger. Let's get some healing items in my inventory. So we can actually start playing the game. I could put stuff on.
But that would make it too easy. He could also turn on the monitor, but we have to make it challenging. what's up? What's up, Pyro?
Yeah, I've played this game. I played a fair amount. Probably three is my least played.
So, for any particular reason, or is that just where it fell?
That's just where it fell. I think two, you know, the thing that I have come to really appreciate about two is how interesting it is, which seems like a fake praise. Ooh, you're so interesting.
Tell me more. Yeah, right. Fill up time on this speed dating. Session that we have here.
I'm just checking my watch for no reason. I'm just checking my watch.
Mm-hmm.
oh wait, why do I have the little shield thing on my body? Chat, why do I have the little shield with the red thing below my stamina and health?
That's interesting. But, yeah. Are you online? Like online?
As in, yes?
Could you get invaded?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Wacky stuff. There we go.
Right. All right, so now we're going to see if we can pull off some shenanigans. I don't know if I'll be able to, but we're going to see if we can.
Go ahead. Yeah, right. The thing that you have on Nick, though, is that you know your way around, apparently.
Yes. Yes, I do. And like I said, I literally just played and beat the game. It was like 11 or 12 hours, or I wrote it down in chat last time.
11 or 12 hours?
Nick was playing.
Wow. All right.
And Nick's on 16, I think.
Yeah, somewhere around there. What is it?
So we're just picking up all the stuff we can from around Majula, and then... Oh, right. Don't forget. One, we gotta talk to the lady.
Oh, I got you, George Lucas. You know, I've got the Notebook of Death right here.
You've got the Notebook of Death?
Yeah, just keeping a tally. I don't think you'll catch Nick in that he's around 175 deaths deep, but he's probably put a dent into it.
He's 175 deaths deep?
Most of it's from falling, if you believe it.
One, I 100% believe it. It's Dark Souls. Platforming sucks.
And what you got a proper question here from Cornballer. Jack, have you ever played Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze for the Nintendo Switch? It has a new Funky Kong mode. It's a Funky Kong believer.
I have not.
It's a backlog. Do you believe in a backlog, Jack? Or do you just, you know, are you more laissez-faire than other gamers?
Do I believe in a backlog? That's an interesting way to put that, Frost.
Wait, because a backlog implies like this almost this duty-bound diligence that you have, this checklist of all these games. Whereas I'm more of like, as it goes.
I love that laissez-faire attitude. Along with my immense Catholic and liberal guilt, I feel like I need a backlog.
Okay.
You know, like I have a backlog because I need penance. You know.
Right. Need to hurt myself to keep track of it, or I won't get anything done.
Right, and there are the unfortunate part is there are so many games that I wish to play that you never will, and you'll forget about, and then you'll hear about it later, and people will say, oh, it's okay, or whatever, right?
But it's not okay. But it's flagellated not okay. Over this backlog.
Well, and it's tricky because, like, I picked up, over the weekend, I picked up a fun game on Steam that is a deck building. Tower defense game, and someone's gonna ask what it's called. Someone surely is gonna ask what it's called. So I will tell you that it is called Heretic's Fork.
Oh, I saw that one. It's the Raven Age guys, isn't it?
Yes.
That's the problem. Yeah, they always. I've got, I guess, friends. I don't know if acquaintances. Yeah, they're showing me off a lot of their game. I saw that one. I was like, this is a strange, funky little fella, but I have a code. I haven't had time to play it. If I believed in a backlog, it would surely be there. How is it?
You're telling me you do not. Well, I guess, yeah, real quick. It's good. It's very good. It is exactly what it says it is on the box, which is a deck building tower defense game. If you're expecting more or less. Oh, crap. You will be disappointed.
Love it.
But are you telling me you do not believe in a backlog?
No. Because I think I just, if I were to believe in one, it would just be, maybe I'm just in denial. It would just be, it caused too much executive dysfunction. Just Ooh. Too much overload of like, oh, there's so many things to do. I'll never catch up. I'm just going to sit here and play more Super Mario Galaxy. But so maybe that denial of a backlog is the thing that kind of keeps me on track.
Ooh, I mean,
there is no pressure. It's fine if you play Bioshock now. No one's judging you. It's not like, you know, Armored Core and Baldur's Gate 3 and Starfield just came out.
Yeah,
Go ahead. Let's talk about Bioshock Infinite 10 years later. Yeah, backlog is in reality Pandora's box. You don't go back, exactly. So while you use your guilt to power you through, I use denial. With the seven deadly sins of games journalism.
It didn't work. Oh, it didn't work. Damn it. I'm trying to use the... okay, that's one death to gravity.
Oh, to a fall. Yeah, gravity.
It's been a while, and actually, I don't think I did this on my test playthrough, but there is the incredible Dragon Rider cheese that I'm trying to accomplish to get a whole bunch of souls right away to level up for, you know, to make the rest of the game slightly easier, but...
Where'd you find these strategies? Speedrunning forums, or is this your own?
Right, you know, you're just on the... No, this is not my own. This is... You're part of the community. You watch a million videos on Dark Souls 2, and eventually, like, people keep doing the same thing. What is that? That's a strategy.
Right.
Like, there's just all sorts of things, of little things. Oh, crap. There we go. And I think you're supposed to wait for him to actually wind up.
Okay.
Here we go. Boom. And that's the Dragon Rider.
Oh my god. This is something new. This is different.
Yeah, so now we have a bunch of souls to start off with.
I love it. This is my kind of power fantasy that I go for.
Right.
Because I don't believe in playing fair with From Software, because they don't play fair with you.
Anything that's part of the game code is part of the game code. And there's a part of me that feels like it is intentional. Because you know, you have the option to raise up the arena. Like, what you're supposed to do in that is, like, make your way around all the stone guardians, raise up the arena so it's a nice big arena for you to fight in. And right. If you don't raise up the arena, it makes it really easy for the Dragon Rider to fall off. So there's part of me that's like, maybe they did it on purpose.
Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, conceptualization. I love how Frost isn't used to the hyper competence. It's like, oh, that is uber competence. It's beyond competence. The vegan alternative to competence.
Right.
Wow.
All right. So we are going to go this. I think this will do me for now. I don't have a plan. I never have a plan for my like stats. Maybe I don't need that much adaptability yet. I like a fair amount of adaptability.
Alright. I'm a faster chugs.
Faster chugs, more iframes. There's like a special. There's a special amount of adaptability that hits you like to a really good amount of iframes.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I like to hit.
Alright.
Let's see here. Oh, wait. Isn't there a... I think there's another thing over here.
I didn't know what I was walking into this stream.
God. Hyper-competence, my friend.
Competence, man's naked with a dagger.
Yeah.
Yeah, and should I get Burger King or Wendy's? After that, no, Jack, what the hell was that? It's like, no, Jack, what should I have for lunch?
Burger King or Wendy's, that's a tough call. Okay, controversial opinion here, Frost. I'm a fan of Burger King. I like Burger King.
Oh, as is mine.
Oh, okay.
There we go.
There you go. Boom, get Burger King.
We know we're the outcast, though, so...
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
100%. Rusted coin. Boo.
Hmm.
Yeah, so my first priority is to get my preferred weapon, which is I'm gonna go club. We're gonna go clubbing.
Oh, yeah. I see. And what does Jack think about Demon Souls, the Holy Beginnings? Did you start at Demon Souls, or did you go back? Or did you even play it?
I played the remake of Demon's Souls. I never played the original. I want to say we tinkered back in the previously recorded days, which is the stream that I did years ago with my friend Rich Evans. I want to say we tinkered around a little bit in Demon's Souls. Am I going to regret this? Maybe. But I forget. But I did do the remake. No, the first From Software game I played was Bloodborne.
Oh, you got a good start.
We tried to stream a little bit of Dark Souls, and the chat was absolutely insufferable.
Oh, no.
And they were not helpful at all. And they were so unhelpful that I was sworn off of the Souls games for quite a long time. Then after Bloodborne... Oh, crap. Realizing, you know, how wonderful and beautiful these games are. This is a bad idea.
I give in another try to the community.
You give in to the what?
That you figured you'd give the community another try. Then.
Well, you know, once I was done with community shenanigans, I just played Dark Souls on my own and for a long time didn't get it. You know, like coming from Bloodborne, Dark Souls is very different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like they really encourage stuff like the old turtle strats, the old poke and whatnot, right?
Poke and runs.
And so I definitely did not get it at first, but I do remember like hitting a point in which I figured out the tricks to the game. And it was marvelous. It was a marvelous time. Oh, crap. Oh, I did such a bad thing. Oh, I did such a bad thing, Frost.
You're being naughty. Oh, no.
Yeah, you know, you want to try to... I was trying to run past all these people, but... Oh, nope. Okay, there's death, too.
All right. Natural causes.
Old age. I died of old age.
Yeah, old age. You saw him. He was rusty and crusty on the way out.
I always forget, like, where's the areas where you have to kill people, and where's the areas where you can run past, and that's a have to kill people kind of area.
I imagine you have seen like a speed run of any of these, just in general, not in prepping. But I mean, I get curious. I'd just be browsing, mm-hmm. and I go, finally, I beat this game. It only took me 80 hours. Speed run, 1 hour. Well, good on me now, I guess.
Right. I've watched speedruns. My issue, like, usually I try not to pay too much attention because I'm getting ganked. I prefer like glitchless.
Yeah. I'll look for the glitchless runs, not the any percent.
Yeah.
Because okay. It's like that's where I go. That's too far. I'll do the 7 steps to the Dragon Rider, sure, but I don't feel like going through walls and clipping.
Right, yeah, doing that thing where it's like, if you do this, the camera acts a certain way, and then you get to like clip through stuff. Yeah, I could, mostly just because I don't know how, and so right. Many of those are like, you know, you have to be pixel perfect. With this one, and after, you know, 5 years of trying, I just mastered the technique. I don't have time for that.
No.
Nope. Oh my god. Shaking that rust off, Frost. Shaking that rust off.
It always starts off just like this. I think most of Nick's deaths were in the first stream.
Right?
Then after that, it's like, maybe 10 here and there.
Just shaking that rust off. We're going to be fine, everybody. Don't you worry. We're still going to get, in this stream, we are going to get significantly farther than Nick got in his first stream.
You have any interest in Lies of P? New Souls-like?
It's so tricky. You know, morbid curiosity, yes. I haven't heard anything about it from people's whose opinion I consistently agree with.
Right.
You know?
Wording on that. I was like, wait a minute. Who are you waiting to give the call?
Because, like, there's a lot of people who, whose opinions... Oh, fuck. There's a lot of people whose opinions I sometimes agree with. And there's a lot of people who, like, whose opinions, like, I can trust. And then there's some people whose opinions I cannot trust. Here we go. This is how we do it. This is how we do it. So there's a few, especially when it comes to the Souls community, there's a few people whose opinions I consistently agree with, and I'm waiting to hear from them on whether or not Lies of P is a good or a bad.
Would you be willing to say who those peoples are?
Whose opinions I trust?
Not so much, because you're not saying, oh, these guys are liars and these guys are trustworthy. What you're saying is that their opinions reflect yours enough to
Be worth
comparison, obviously. So, like, who is your, I would say, your soul's Sherpa? Because, like, mine, I'm close to Vadi in the lore style of things. Just because he likes the game doesn't mean I'll enjoy it myself, but if he likes the map, I'm probably going to enjoy the map.
Ah, sure. Okay.
I know some people have, like Iron Pineapple.
Yeah.
He's a...
Iron Pineapple, I think, is someone whose opinion I find myself agreeing with a lot. Backlogs. I don't know if you've ever seen any Backlogs videos. You know, Backlogs doesn't do many new videos. Or, I'm sorry, many new games. Here we go. Now we got the club. Now we're ready to go. We need that key... And I can't afford a branch.
Does it rhyme with banshee? Are you trying to say Yahtzee? I don't think. Do they rhyme? I suppose.
Banshee, I'm not sure if he's doing Yahtzee. Life
with me. Banshee, Yahtzee. The A's would. Yeah.
Yahtzee, I sometimes agree with. I don't. You know, we don't always see eye to eye. I always appreciate. I think, you know, Yahtzee is one of those critics that. You know, obviously I work with now, but back when I just watched Yahtzee, I enjoyed what Yahtzee had to say because I always thought he did a really good job of articulating his ideas. Right.
Yeah, we're all waiting on Darren, really. That's the go-ahead.
Oh, I love Darren.
Darren loved Lies of P. Here we go.
Darren loved Lies of P. All right, now. Oh, now we got the club. Now we're ready to go.
There you go.
All right. I think I can level up again, so I think I'm going to go do that.
Love the data miners like Zuli. I love watching Zuli the Witch. This, like, look what I found in the files. Like, oh.
Zuli's great. You're a felon. You know, like, there are so many people who, you know, do really fun, like, especially Elden Ring. Like, you know, Tulok, I've mentioned several times. Tulok, the Bard Barian, like, Bushy. Little Aggie does some really fun Elden Ring speed runs. There's a ton of amazing creators out there who have a lot of fun with that. Seek Lest, yes. Oh, crap.
Who's your favorite for builds? Who do you think consistently has, like, the weirdest builds that makes you go, I kind of want to try that?
Oh, Distortion. Back when Elden Ring was first out, there was a streamer called Distortion 2, I want to say. Someone can correct me if I'm wrong. They were the person that did, like, beat Elden Ring only with the butt slam. Beat Elden Ring only with the Sonic the Hedgehog electric spin. And that was some bizarre bullshit that I loved an incredible amount.
Oh, is that what inspired you? What was it? Your cannon only run?
The cannon only, exactly. Yeah, those. I want to say it was Little Aggie who did the consumables only.
Okay. Did you see? There was a guy. His name. Well, his tag is Gino Machino. He did the perfect any percent no hit run of Demon Souls, Dark Souls 1, 2, 3, Bloodborne, Sekiro, and Elden Ring. If you get hit once, you have to start over.
Jesus.
He just perfected all of them.
That's insanity.
Absolutely.
Absolute insanity.
Kids don't need sleep these days.
You know, I mean, good for them. Good for, you know, if that's what they can do, good for them. All right, we got the locksmith. We got the blacksmith.
Oh, is that what they call it now? The God Run? Oh, God.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
What if they immortalize him in the next Souls game?
Right.
Name one after him. Gino Machino.
Gino Machino. Love it. All right. We're going to just see if I can buff up my club a little bit here before we go take on some tougher enemies.
All right. So where do we head from here? Who is your next target boss, I guess?
Next, we got to go Giant. We got to go Last Giant because, and then, right. So we're going to go Last Giant, then we're going to go Pursuer so we can get to that area. Is the plan. Who knows if it's going to happen?
Mm-hmm.
Thought I bought another shard. I am sorry.
They immortalize him for us. You can use his story for stuff of legends. See, I was wondering on that. There are some legends in Dark Souls. Gino and Let Me Solo Her with Elden Ring.
Beautiful. That's a beautiful legend. Absolutely.
That is a good one. I was like, maybe I wait till there's more legends.
Why?
Have one that it's an anthology.
Okay, sure.
Is it a bit too presumptuous to call a legend? It's only a year old.
What's only a year old?
You're like, Let Me Solo Her. The story of that is. Like,
are you telling me that's recent. Not a legend already? Is that?
I don't know.
Is that what you are saying? Because that, I mean,
I say I'm too close. I'm too close to say if it is or isn't.
Ah. I think that is 100% a legend already.
100%? All right.
But I agree. Like, there are also so many more stories to tell. So, you know, I don't think you need to stress about it.
Mm-hmm. The way I see it is, if like one game has too many legends, I want to hit one and then have a nice gap before I return to it. So if I were to have like who would be the first From Software legend, I feel like it would be Miyazaki before anyone else.
It better be. But you know, is the story of how what would be the legend? You know, what's the story?
Of what? Let me solo her?
Of Miyazaki. Is there an interesting, like, you know, is there an interesting story there about, like, how he got his start, how he got a game made, that sort of thing?
Yeah, he was an accountant until, like, his late 30s, and then he just, he played Ico and said, this is what I want to do with my life. I never had any ambitions, no dreams, no plans. Played Ico, and I was like, I want to make games. So he went to From Software, he's like, let me be a janitor, and it was basically Goodwill Hunting.
That's an amazing story that I did not know.
That is a summation of it, but yeah, he's got weird backstories all over the place.
That's lovely.
Like, all kinds of design choices he makes.
My cat is upset and trying to get inside my office. And the dog is blocking his path in. I would not venture, so I have to open my door wider.
Excuse me, are you in or out? To be certain, but
I've heard disturbing noises. Okay. We got the map maker's key.
Lovely. Yeah, I will have to figure out his love for poison swamps. I'm not sure where that come from.
I don't think that needs an explanation. Like, it's an area that kills you by just being in it. Like, what other explanation do you need?
I don't know. It just tickles him, doesn't he? Yeah. He does not have any formal training in game development. He comes from obviously accounting, but also I think his secondary was his minor was sociology.
Ah.
Yeah, so he's trying to get in your head. And I think at times he shows what's in his. It's like, all right.
Good.
He's like, I'm just going to have a mushroom in this forest that punches you. Just out of nowhere.
Love it. I love it. One, I love that mushroom. Two, I love it. All right. There we go. Got out the shortcut first try. Usually that shortcut takes me an embarrassing long amount, an embarrassing amount of time to get.
Oh, I couldn't even find it before. Oh, yeah, it's funny. This is a very different experience. Nobody's backseating you. Because when Nick does it, he's like, "So here, let me help you, ma'am." He's like, "No, I've got it. I've got it. The door where? Right there."
You know, it's like part of me, now that I know stuff about these games, almost understands the reception I got when I was playing. Because if you do know something, like, one, you're eager to share that knowledge.
Yeah.
And two, it's just like, why haven't you figured this out? I figured this out. you know, like, there's a bit of an ego, but, you know, like, everyone remember that streaming a game is significantly more different than playing a game not streaming.
Yeah. So also with my memory, because I go, I don't know how people couldn't get into Dark Souls 1. And then I played it again, and then I went, oh, damn, that's right. This was very obtuse. I had a friend playing with me at the time, telling me where to go.
Right.
I'm Isalti with the 10 plinths. Jack, remove skeleton. A blast from the past.
There it is.
Remove skeleton.
That was the meme that when I was first streaming Dark Souls, they kept saying, I was a little concerned that, like I didn't know what it meant. I didn't know what remove skeleton meant. And my big concern was that, like, it was some sort of, like, racist slang. And I was like, what the hell does this mean? But it's just like lightening your equipment load, right?
Remove skeleton?
Is just like lightening your load so you're fast rolling, so you're removing your skeleton.
Okay. I'm not too deep. I get the lore of the games. I'm not hip with the lingo. Is there anything else we need to know?
It's one of those things where it's like, though, like saying remove skeleton to someone, again, who knows nothing about Dark Souls means nothing.
You're too deep.
Yeah. Y'all are too deep. I think there's something. Is there something over here? Oh, yeah. Here's a thing. Yeah, well, that's a good one. It's just remembering where all the things are. That's so difficult sometimes.
Yeah. Speaking of that, so Megatelica, would you and Rich ever consider doing some more previous rec?
That's not up to me. That is.
Yeah, you gotta go ask Rich.
Yeah, that's my my constant statement is one of us still streams and the other does not. So, you might want to ask the one who is not streaming. So take that for what it's worth. Oh no, am I gonna get through? Come on. Yes. All right. Good. 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 We're doing it. We're doing it. We're getting through.
Oh, look at that. Look at that. Oh, that's right. The pursuer is optional. I forgot about that.
Well, the first pursuer.
It's like two pursuers deep, aren't you?
I did not do the first pursuer only because, like, I'm still relatively weak, and my plan is to cheese the pursuer. I'm going to go for the artillery kill.
Okay. All right.
Just because I'm not that strong, and while the pursuer's fight is, like, easily done, he's an enemy that really telegraphs his attacks. I just want it to be done with faster. So,
I think this is about as far as we got on the first stream.
Yeah, did he beat the last giant on the first stream?
Yeah, I think he got the giant, and then it was right before the pursuer.
Oh, yeah, I think you're right. I think
because he got lost for a bit.
He kept dying to the pursuer. Is what I think it is. Oh, I love this fight. I love this enemy. I love how he comes back later. I love this. You know, like playing this game, not knowing anything about it. Even this, like, ultra simplistic design of a giant, of just like a hole for a face, is so evocative. I love it. And that's the thing about this game, is like it's so interesting. There are so many fascinating things. And even though it's kind of janky, all those fascinating things really speak louder. Than the jank.
Here's the thing. So From Software likes to show, aside from Sekiro, they like to show you're in a world that is falling apart. How hard do you think everything would be if they made a game where everything was in its prime?
Ooh, interesting.
It's always like, oh, it's rotting, it's falling apart, we're doing this again. Like, now it's like, oh, everything's in its prime. Who do you think would be the most dangerous?
Ah, that's very fun. That's a fun idea.
Yeah, Sekiro was falling apart, but you did get to fight that one guy when he was younger.
That's a very interesting concept. I'm trying to think of a good answer. One, it would be a very fun game. But let's see here. Are you saying which current enemy would be the hardest if they were in their prime?
Yeah.
Cool.
Soul's world in its prime was full of dragons. Yeah, you got dragons you got to worry about.
That would probably be my guess, is like there would be a ton of dragons. But then, like, you know, if you just think about Gwyn, like Gwyn gathered an army and took down the dragons, and so like we're not dealing with mindless soldiers, we're dealing with like a commander and king in his prime, with a legion of soldiers also in their prime. Ooh, baby. Even Vendrick here, the king of Dark Souls 2, you know, formidable opponent, defeated the giants, right?
Yeah, no, any of the kings, that would probably be the best option. The last is wondering, what's your favorite Souls boss?
I might be a little biased because it's also the, you know, one of the newest and therefore like the freshest in my mind. But why are you whining? My puppy is whining because I'm not petting her. Horaloo.
Which one's that? I'm bad with names.
Horaloo is the real version of Godrick, King Godrick in Elden Ring.
Ah, okay.
After he rips the lion off of him and is just full primal power.
Yeah, he's a wrestler there. Okay. Favorite boss.
Like, to me, the Horaloo fight is, you know, one, it's anime as fuck. Like, just, you know, throwing people in the air, and you are up against this super ripped muscle dude who can tear you apart and does tear you apart.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh,
fucking love it. Fucking love it.
Funny, I think the one that stands out to me the most, and it might be because it's a little bit silly, or maybe I like the arena and the little story around it. I loved the fight with Radahn on his little tiny horse. Like,
Yeah.
I think that's probably one of the more standout ones. I'm also a big sucker for Sif just because of the storytelling. Mm-hmm. Like I fought him twice because I wanted to see them both, and I felt bad both times.
Absolutely. Radahn is very fun. Radahn is a very, very fun image. Almost like a ridiculous image is what it is, right?
Yeah, it's like I learned, what is it, gravity powers just so I can keep my horse up.
And what's the horse? The horse has a name.
I don't remember.
The code, the horse has a name. Like, it's never mentioned in game, but in the code of the game, they gave the horse a name. Sorry, someone in chat will know. It's because it's a stupid name. It's very silly. Leonard. That's what it is. It's Leonard the horse.
Yeah. Because from Latin, it means brave lion. Sure, but it's Leonard.
But it's Leonard.
Yeah. Don and Leonard's horse. Love it. It goes crazy. It's also the atmosphere is so weirdly celebratory but bitter, because it's like, wait, well, we're here for a fight, you know. Yep. It's a big feast and a big fantastical event, all these people fighting with you, and it's somber, but it's supposed to be exciting at the same time. And then he turns into a meteor in the middle of it. What the fuck?
And again, like, incredible that, you know, that game really nails the superpowers that I think the other Souls games don't embrace, which is like, oh, you thought this fight was tough. Guess what? It is tougher because he is coming down as a meteor. Do I want to go this way?
They definitely went crazy in Elden Ring. Would you say it's the most anime of them all? In general?
And I say that with an incredible amount of love, that it's the most anime of them all. Because, like, it's those moments. It's those, like, a boss pauses to wind up extra hard moments that gives you the opportunity to dodge and feel like you are also super powered.
And then a big cutscene where his dragon head turns into his arm. Like, crazy.
Right?
How could you not?
It's beautiful is what it is. All right, come here, you guys. Nope.
Ooh.
There we go. We got to open a door now, so we have to actually fight these guys.
Lord Gwyn was wonderfully pathetic as the final boss, but wonderfully thematic as well.
Absolutely.
I wonder if they would ever give in and just like, here, let's make a Souls game where it's a world in its infancy, if not prime at least. Like, this is when it's coming up.
It's an interesting concept because, you know, what's the story that they want to tell? And, you know, with the Souls games, usually the story is about, you know, the inevitability of death and, you know, like the futility of trying to stop nature itself, right?
I don't know. The arrogance of the young.
ooh, that's a good theme.
It's just the raw energy and the lack of focus. Marty coming through with his favorite. But Don and Gwyn are cool, but nothing beats the royal rat authority. Just a shit ton of little guys scurrying about. A-plus boss.
Rat authority, right?
Yeah, I like those every now and again. You know, it's not the hardest boss you've ever faced, but by God, you remember them.
Right?
Oh, here we go.
You know, you need stuff like that for the ups and downs.
Mm-hmm.
For the memes. You need the memes. You know, like the even like the Renala fight in Elden Ring, where, you know, your first phase is just murdering children and it's
awkward.
Just murdering her little babies. All right, we're going to see if we can do this. It's been a while. I did this in my test run.
Okay.
So we're just going to see if I can be fast enough. Oh, I fucking love the Pursuer. This guy fucking, he fucks. Oh, I love him so much, Frost.
Dude's a big round armor.
Oh, look at him. Look at him. Oh, he's got the glowing eyes and the big ass sword and shield and all the extra swords.
Marsden.
I feel like this... The Pursuer is the most underutilized character in all of Souls. This is the character we all want to be.
Yeah, so much fanfare. And then it's just, random fights here and there.
All right, so if we do that and then... Yep. Oh, I got you, you son of a bee. Well, now I gotta fight him for real.
Oh, he broke it.
Yeah, he broke it. Don't know. I might be able to beat him for real.
So what happens when your Dark Souls character, if they grind too long, you turn into the Pursuer?
I always assumed that was going to be like the final boss. You know, it's like you turn, you know, the Pursuer was trying to stop you.
Yeah.
From becoming, you know, the Pursuer.
didn't know the pursuer could do that. Oh yeah, he breaks his shit.
Oh yeah, he breaks stuff. She's gotta be patient now. Now she's gonna take longer. There we go. Alright. I beat him the old-fashioned way.
Yeah, on the first try, still record time right now.
Oh, thank God. We're feeling pretty darn good.
Not even the hour in, and we're already two episodes through the original stream. Yeah. It's all that adaptability. You know, maybe the chat was right. They were harassing us for a while.
And it's, you know, obviously, like, Dark Souls 2 is very different than the other Souls games, but adaptability is actually incredibly useful. It's what gives you them iframes. All right. There we got that. All right, we're doing great, everybody. We're doing great. I want to look at that instant replay. I thought I got the ballista off in time. I was pretty darn sure that I got that ballista off. But... Oh, no, I don't want to read the message. No, stop reading the message.
Your character's reminding me of the Northmen. Of all the naked men with clubs, how'd you pinpoint the Northmen?
I'll take the Northmen. You better beat the game before end of stream. Not going to happen, even though we have been given permission to stream a little bit longer than usual. I definitely, like I said, I wanted to make a statement here. I wanted to kick down the door and just make sure that... I was living up to my full potential, and already we've beaten three bosses in an hour. Feeling pretty darn good about that.
Yeah, where are we now? Oh, the Bastille already. Okay.
Yeah, Bastille. So we're doing pretty good, and I figured something out actually for the first time in my run that I just did when Nick started streaming. Which was like the proper way to do things to make the last sinner, or the lost sinner, more of a bearable fight.
Which one's the sinner?
The one in the dark room.
Oh, okay, yeah. We gotta turn the lights on.
I figured out and I always forget like what the proper order is to do things in which to turn the lights on in general. But. And my big mistake was in my other playthrough, I used the Pursuer's soul to get the Pursuer's sword, which is so badass. But I ended up just using the club.
I couldn't help myself. I had to.
It's so cool. Frost, the sword is so cool.
I am bad about customization and making decisions, so I don't know what it looks like. Is it just his sword, one he fights you with?
It's just his sword. It doesn't do the cool things that his sword does, but yeah, it's just his sword.
I'm a hoarder when it comes to RPGs. I don't use anything, and I just walk in very basic sword and shield.
That's fair. That's really... eventually, I'm going to want armor, so we should do that. And then just strength, strength, strength. And then, I got to look up. Hold on, I got to look up adaptability really quick.
I know.
Because it's like Dark Souls 2 adaptability to iframes. There's like a calculator.
I think someone said it was maybe 24.
Here it is. So if I can get agility to 95, that gives me 10 iframes, and that's pretty good. So that's what I'm going to look for, is I'm going to look to get agility to 95.
All right.
Okay, so my agility right now is 89, not too bad.
Oh, we're closer than I thought, don't you know?
All right, so if we go to 90, that gives us an extra iframe. That'll do pretty good. Maybe vitality, strength. And we're doing all strength weapons here. I'm going to do the club until I can get the reinforced club.
Gotcha. How many times has Jack died? Just three.
Three deaths, three bosses. Feeling pretty good so far. What do I need here? I need three shards. Can I afford three shards, sir? I can afford two shards. I will buy two shards. Sir, please, I would like some more shards. Right.
That's cheating. I'm pulling up Google.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah, I'm pulling up Google. We have it, you know, and it's this is the bigger conversation, Frost, which is
bigger than both of us.
Is using the community cheating?
I'd say, so the way I go is I do a virgin run. First one is just me on my own prowess. After that, I go nuts.
Okay.
Do whatever you want.
I love that. I think that is one that is correct. always good to just... Mostly, I think mostly you need to do a virgin run just so you know what the community is talking about.
Yeah, that too. Yeah.
What?
It's like trying to speak to these people and you don't really know the language.
Yeah.
Like, I even turn it to offline mode because, like, surely, did you play Elden Ring when it first came out?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, the messages everywhere. And I had to stop and click on them. And I was like, I'm not going to make any progress at this rate. So I just turn it to straight offline mode.
Oh, and you know, like I hated it and I loved it. I hated it because of the trolling and I loved it because of the trolling.
Right.
Right? Where it's just like the amount of times they tricked me into thinking it was illusory wall.
No.
Right, we'll see if we can beat the pursuer again.
Or the blood stains. I'm like, Jesus Christ, there's a massive, like, massacre here. What happened? And it's just people killing themselves to poke fun at you.
Right.
They committed to the bit. No. I've been there. Nick has used Google Adder for a few things. Not him directly, but I was the one doing it. Or we just asked the chat.
Yeah. No, and I think, like, part of that is intended. I think, like, they want the community to be involved. They want you to talk to your friends about video games, right? And, you know, our friends are now the internet.
Yeah. This is an interesting one, Milky Pussy. I agree, except for ending requirements. Always look them up since you might not play a second run, get the ending you want first time. I know a lot of people who do that.
Oh.
It's almost a staple for Metroidvanias that have the whole... Like, here's one ending, here's another ending, and then the true ending, quote-unquote.
So, sure.
I wouldn't say anything against it.
Come on. I'm going to die to some goddamn dogs. I just beat the pursuer again, and I'm going to die to some dogs now.
Oh, yeah. The cognitive dissonance is too much.
The cognitive dissonance. Of what?
You just face off the pursuer?
Yeah.
Fine, but just dying to a...
Okay, yeah. Oh, no. Sorry, I thought that was in response to something chat said.
No.
Right? Oh, fuck you, mister.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There's no chance Jack can beat the three ruined sentinels. This is his end. Do you have lightning for them? What's your plan for them?
The ruined sentinels? I'm going to hit them with my club.
All right, I like this.
I think my biggest problem right now is I don't know if I have a fragrant branch of yore. But I do. That's the next. That's the next thing. We're gonna go there next, so that we can get the Bastille jailer's key, so that we can open up the gates to light the things to make the lost sinner easier.
All right. Normal.
But we're going to talk to this person because I like talking to this person.
What is this? The dude who eats pianos, 732. Frost and Jack, if you could make any soulsish boss into a stuffed animal, which would it be and why? Artorias. Give me Artorias. Easy. A massive Artorias body pillow with the limp arm. I'll put it around me as I go to sleep.
With the lip arm. That's pretty good. Like that. You know, like, give me a Sif with a stuffed sword in his mouth, right? Like, that could be fun.
You got some Onion Bros, some Patches the Spider. Okay.
Patches the Spider. Only the Spider version, though.
Yeah, the Spider version of him. You got Calamite. Gaping dragon? Oh no.
Alright.
The covetous demon? Oh, Quelag, Quelanas.
Oh, dang.
Ooh. Oh,
that's four. Oh, that's four to technically gravity.
Oh. The environment. Big killer.
Technically, gravity, you might be able to call that an enemy kill because there was an enemy in the way that made me die to gravity. So, depends on how you want to play it.
Here's a mod that I would give Secondborn for. An OSHA-approved Dark Souls. So, like, everything meets safety requirement. There's rails, right? The bosses are taken care of. you're wearing high-vis outfit, right?
Oh, sure.
We're not talking baby-fied. I'm talking, like, yeah. This meets code standards.
This meets code. I think that's very funny. I like that.
Because there's all kinds of things that'll make the game harder, but has anyone actually like set out to make mods that make the game easier in that way? Safer?
Oh my god. The barrel didn't blow up.
Oh. You have fire on you?
I don't know if I have a bomb on me.
Nick had a fire sword once.
Hold on, I think I can get these guys to blow it up.
Oh, yeah.
Come here. Blow up the barrel. There we go. I might die again, but let's see if I can. There we go. Nope. Can't. Okay. All right. No, that's fine. That's fine. I didn't want to use it anyway. I didn't want to use it anyway. I wanted to kill you first. Oh, wait. Now maybe I can use it. There we go. All right. Great. We did it. We got to the next blacksmith. So we can upgrade our sheet a little bit more.
Oh, loathsome dung eater plushie.
Oh my god.
I think I found him the creepiest of all the Souls characters.
Oh, sure.
Especially after watching the lore video behind him. The whole, I think Japanese mythology. Your soul is there.
Yes.
Essentially.
Is like so in your colon.
Yeah. Or your prostate or wherever is. He is essentially eating your soul. Like, okay. He's a weirdo.
Oh yeah.
God, one of that.
No, it's you know, like it's beautiful and a little interesting and just it's just weird. Loathsome dung eater.
I'd totally put railings on the Death Star. Kidding me?
I mean, you need to. How many stormtroopers are they losing?
Right, like those floors slick.
Yeah.
No railings on the inside? No.
Think about it. Can I buy...
That's actually what happened to Ben Kenobi. He didn't die. He tripped. And they had to try and cover it up.
Classic.
Yeah, because killing your enemy is no fine. Somebody tripping, get sued?
Yeah. Ooh. What do I need? I need three large titanite shards. Okay. Doing great. Large titanite shard. Can I buy two? Oh, I'll buy two. Oh, nice. Nice. We're doing great, everybody. We're doing great. We are making our way. Oh, I still need a goddamn fragrant branch of Yore. That's right.
Where do you get those from? What is the lore of the Yore?
What is the... Where can I... do I gotta go to Pickle Pea? Is that where I gotta go? Do I gotta go to Pickle Pea, y'all? Because I will. Don't think I won't go to Pickle Pea. Do I even have... Oh, no, I do have a fragrant branch of Yore. Oh, never mind. Shit.
Oh,
all
right. We're here. What you know?
Well, then we're here. Great. We're doing.
All right. So next on the list is the center. Okay.
Yes.
Wait, are the sentinels optional? I don't know what's optional in here.
Oh yeah.
Like
no,
Dark Souls 1, only four bosses are optional. This one has a lot.
This one has a lot of optional bosses, and the sentinels are optional. A lot of the bosses are very optional in this game. The sentinels, like I'm choosing to do them because they give you the boost for the Lost Sinner.
Right.
So I'm going to do them because, or after them, I believe after them you can find the, oh crap. I didn't know these guys were going to come.
Oh crap.
Oh,
there okay. He is.
Everything's fine.
Oh, God.
Drink. And let me get inside of you. Hit. Nope. Oh my God. Big whiff, everybody. Everything's fine. Everything's going to be fine.
Oh.
Luckily, the hitboxes aren't incredible in Dark Souls 2, so we can get around things. Here we go.
Adaptability, putting in the work.
You need to. Like, I think adaptability is a bit of a... Oh, crap, died. Adaptability is a bit of a meme, if we're going to be honest. But it's really useful. If I could get to that 10, you know, I'm at 9 iframes right now, which is pretty good. If I can get to that 10.
Let me see here. Before we got to the ruined sentinels. Because we're at 5 deaths now.
Yeah.
Let me see here. Pursuer. I'm looking for the first death to the sentinels. Oh, there it is. So we've got a bit, damn.
Wow. Excuse you. Pursuer. No, and if I was smart, I could put on some armor.
Okay, so we're at 5 deaths here. By now, Nick's already died 31 times. So we'll make a good time, good progress all around. And a Tsunami Usher, $2. Does Pickle Pea look like Ornifex? Who is Ornifex?
I assume Ornifex is the crow that takes you to the fireplace in Dark Souls 1.
Oh, that's right. They have names.
Or is Ornifax? Oh no, is Ornifax the blacksmith?
I think the blacksmith.
No? Oh, okay. Oh God, I hope Pickle Pea doesn't look like Ornifax. Ornifax is creepy.
I was saying, Jack, 99 agility is 12 frames, which is one frame below fast roll in Dark Souls 1. They just gave it to us for free.
Yes. So very true. They just gave it to us for free.
No way he gets past sentinels. His hubris has doomed himself. we're gonna do it. We got plenty of time.
What do we got? Oh, yeah. We got so much time. My stamina is becoming a bit of a problem.
Right.
So, like,
boss weapons.
Boss weapons.
So, do you have a favorite? What was your favorite boss weapon?
My favorite boss weapon?
Pursuer sword.
So cool! It's so cool, but it's one of it. It feels the worst, you know. This game, a lot of things in Dark Souls 2 feel bad to use. And if we're gonna be honest, like, you know, there's some jank here.
A lot of buyer's remorse, he says. I never regretted. Who was it? The flaming sword in the first one. I think it was Quaylag's soul that you used.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah.
That was fancy. I was wearing like Havel's armor and just doing flips and stuff.
Oh, yeah. No, that was cool. I'm trying to think if I use boss weapons, and I oftentimes don't. I'm a player that likes to pick a thing and go with it.
Oh, yeah.
You know, like, this is my thing. I'm just going to make this as strong as I possibly can. All right, here we go.
It's like I've invested. It just, it grows, it gets sentimental.
Oh, 100%.
You can't out. No weapon outscales the sentimental value of the first one I had.
Yes, in a perfect world, it's like, oh no, I have one weapon,
mm-hmm.
and this is my weapon for this run. Like the thing that I will look up online all the time is like how to get the weapons the fastest.
Right.
Because that's all I want. Like, how do I get this weapon that I want as fast as possible so I can use it against as many bosses as I possibly can?
Right. I think my thing is, I always just end up with a holy weapon, just because I don't like dealing with skeletons.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. So, like, in Elden Ring, I had the big winged scythe thing. I just held on to that the whole time.
Oh, that's a good one.
It is. Oh, my God, you are hitting hard.
Oh, yeah. You know, once you understand scaling, right? And the club, like, this club is a great scaling weapon. It scales phenomenally with strength, but it's still light, so it, like, it doesn't cost a terrible amount of stamina to swing it. Excuse you. Oh, crap.
Like, you are staggering, man. Is it a great club?
I died to gravity!
Oh, no. A few more guardrails, a couple signs.
I died to gravity. Oh, for shame. I have brought shame upon my house. Oh, house, gravity. Cow.
You're number one chicken. Yeah, gravity claims yet another victim. Once I tally these, I want to make a pie chart. Like, here are all your deaths, Nick. Here's how many times you fell.
Oh, that was my fault. That was my fault. No. That. Bannon Bomb. Here's the more upsetting part. I did not die to a panic roll. I thought I could survive that fall. Mm-hmm. I just legitimately thought that I could survive that fall, and I couldn't. So that was hubris.
What do you have to scale for that? For fall damage? Is that a thing?
I wonder. That I don't know. I do believe your equipment load is... Wait, you can make this jump, right? Like, this is a jump you can
make. Yeah. Nick died like 10 times trying to make it. You can make it.
Oh, okay, great. I do believe equipment load is a big part of it. And right now I'm naked, so I don't, you know, and I have a club, so I don't have any equipment load.
Yeah.
So I just legitimately thought that I could make it, and I couldn't. Mm. So that's my fault.
All right, now we're back here again. Round two.
Oh my God. And we're not doing as good a job. Oh my God, immediately. Why am I not doing as good of a job already? Oh, crap.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
You wouldn't. All right.
We'll get there. Excuse you. Excuse you, Mr. Ruined Sentinel. I think that was quite rude of you. All right. We're getting there now. There we go. One left. One left. We can do this. Everything's fine. And there we go. Great.
Good God.
Oh, good God. Oh, the ruined sentinels.
I think we've spent less time in boss fights than anything else. Like we're just getting from one place to the other. It's all travel time. We're commuting.
Right?
Oh, God.
Now I have to remember where the... Oh, there it is. I was like, I have to remember where the secrets are. There they are. Here's a secret.
Two Baskin, will Jack be using summons? Do you believe in summons?
I'm okay with summons. I'm not anti-summons. All
right.
So, you know, if I feel like it, I like for story reasons, I really enjoy you can actually get two NPC summons for Nishandra for the final boss. And story lore wise, they're my favorites. I usually do it just for the story.
All right.
Same with
what's their lore?
Oh, you know, like one is almost like your onion bro character who isn't the greatest warrior and has like a counterfeit weapon, but still wants to prove himself, and you help him out in a couple fights, and he, you know, decides to help you at the end, which is beautiful. The other is the headless knight, whose body, like his body leaves him and starts doing evil.
Oh.
And so you destroy his body, and to repay you for destroying his evil body, he helps you in the boss fight, which I think is very fun.
Yeah, this is a different chat experience right here. They're all like, Nick, the secret rooms. Don't forget the secret rooms on your left. Your other left.
It's so important. I don't know if you do get anything terribly important in those secret rooms. Ooh. The thing that we have to find somewhere around here is the key. And I don't quite remember where that is, but... Oh, one of you explodes, right?
Oh.
Do you explode? There it is. I knew somebody exploded.
Oh, that's a little random, wasn't it?
Yeah. Oh, I remember now. Okay, let's, just to be safe, let's go back, level up a little bit, and then we'll take on Pursuer 3. We might be able to get to Lost Sinner before the stream ends, which would be phenomenal.
So right now, for those of you following along at home, we would be on episode 4 of the original. This is the abridged version.
Ooh, okay, we can get to 10 iframes now, which we are going to take.
There you go, I'll POP.
We are going to take 10 iframes, boom. So now we basically no longer have to worry about adaptability, which is preferred. I have some extra crap, though. So let's do...
So what are you boosting now, that adaptability is settled?
Strength. All strength. Now it's just the big three. Now it's just strength, health, and stamina. Eventually, I'm going to want enough... There's a different stat in this one that... governs how much you can carry, and eventually this happy little fella sells the fun good armor, which I can't afford yet, so I'm gonna want that eventually.
Always open for business.
I think I can go in the house. I forget if there's anything good in the house, but let's go in.
There's a cat, I think.
The cat's in the little shack next to the house.
A greeting there, yeah.
We got a Pharaoh's Lockstone.
Nick spent a while faffing around with the Pursuer and Sentinels before he found his footing with the game. Yeah, he had a good spree, and then we got lost again.
But by the way, that's how the game works. Like, you got to figure stuff out. I've played this enough to have figured it out. That's just me having already figured it out.
There we go. With the $2. Frost must be getting deja vu of One Piece on 2x speed. Yeah, this is exactly what it's like. Everything all faster.
Everything all faster.
And everyone's sounding like a chipmunk.
Man, I did enjoy that One Piece live action show.
Oh, yeah. Have you finished?
Yeah, just finished it. My kids, who are big fans of the anime, really wanted me to watch it with them, but they were also watching it with their grandmother.
Okay.
And so they wouldn't, you know, they didn't want me to get like two ahead of them watching it with their grandmother. So we had to wait a little bit. But man, what a fun show.
All right.
What a very fun show.
Loving it. I stopped right after they got done with Usopp. And next, I believe, is Sanji. And that's probably my favorite of the original episodes.
Ah.
I'm like, this guy is so cheesy, and I love everything about him.
Yes.
Where he's like, I am one of the best kickboxers because I refuse to get my hands dirty because I want to cook as well. All right, do you. You think.
Do your thing. Absolutely. Do your thing. I really enjoyed it. I thought it was a tremendous first season. Like, did an incredible job of, balancing, emotional moments. Hello, Mr. Pursuer. With truly ridiculous, goofy bullshit. So I'm here for it.
Heart is there. Are you anticipating more live action adaptations like that?
Well, I know they had they did the what was the other big anime one that didn't do so well?
Death Note. Or Cowboy Bebop.
They did Death Note. Oh, Cowboy Bebop is the one I'm thinking of. They did Cowboy Bebop, and that got pretty middling reviews, if I remember correct.
Right.
And as someone, large club, I watched, I could get a big club.
Oh yeah. More club per club.
I like a club. The only problem is it's too big and it doesn't swing as fast and it eats up all your stamina. Priest channel. Where the F do we get this key? Y'all, I'm sure it's around here somewhere. But I don't know. That would be tough for me because I loved Bebop. I loved me some Bebop back in the day. So I think it would be very difficult for me to watch live action Bebop.
Right. I mean, just in general, adaptations super hit or miss. I'm glad that we're still not out of that because. Maybe this is a weird one. As the adaptations were getting a little bit better, I was going, but we had some good garbage that would just kind of come out of nowhere. It's like, I hope we haven't fully gone past it.
Oh, there it is. The good garbage?
Yeah. Just, I mean, some adaptations were just horrible, horrendous, and I love them for it. It's like, I hope we haven't completely learned our lesson. Zer Arthur with the $2 ERs, Jack Pack back in black, whacking smack on track, ack.
Oh my.
I like that.
That's a whole lot, my friend.
Alright. To the center, you.
Yeah, I could go to the center. I could go to the center now if I wanted to. Why don't we? You know what? Just for shits and giggles, let's go to the center.
Oh yeah. What was the worst one you liked? The worst adaptation I liked? Probably Initial D.
Initial D.
Yeah, if you're not familiar, for those who aren't familiar,
mm-hmm.
It's essentially Tokyo Drift, but as an anime.
All right.
Manga with Tokyo Drift. The live action was it was some garbage, but I loved every second of it.
All right, I can be with you there. I can be with garbage that you love. Sometimes entertainment is entertainment. Full stop, right?
Oh, I'm not going to slap it away. It's like, I was entertained, but the quality.
I had a good time, but at what cost?
At what cost, yeah. My reputation.
Whoa. Easy.
Initial D had a live action. Yeah, they did. And it was interesting because they would do these strange freeze frame things of the people. I'm not sure. It just looked like my stream was buffering the whole time.
Oh, yeah, that's right. These fuckers. Come here. Just looked like my stream was buffering. you know, they it's important to try. I think you're right with like the good garbage, where it's like, I want you to try some weird things. If it works, great. If not, that's okay too.
As far as I don't know if to put it out like that, but what was it, the Street Fighter one with Jean-Claude Van Damme?
Yes,
that to me is like, oh, that is peak. Some peak trash that I absolutely love. They should have given him an Oscar for all this. Beauty. Yeah, punch him again. Yeah, flex and show the flag once
yes.
more.
Yes. Raul Julia, a national treasure.
Yeah, Raul Julia. Oh, it was Tuesday.
For me, it was Tuesday. Oh, what a beautiful man. And then you hear like the behind the scenes story of him just being like, my kids loved Street mm-hmm. Fighter and they wanted me to do it, so I did it. Yeah. Like, good on you, man. Good on you. Like, I got to share this thing with my kids where I was in a thing that they actually wanted to see me in.
Yeah. No, but the part of it is also, I think it was, he was going through cancer
correct.
At the time.
Correct.
Wanting to spend more time with his kids, so he would have them also, like, consulting as well.
Ah.
So they could actually spend time on set. And it's just like, yeah, this is how you're going to go about it.
That's beautiful.
I heard Van Damme was doing so much cocaine during Street Fighter. I think most of Hollywood was back then.
Also, like, you could probably replace Street Fighter with just about anything else Van Damme has been in.
Yeah, just Van Damme.
Just Van Damme. Like, not, I guess, like, just Van Damme and also, like, the time.
Yeah, like, the signs were all there. He had cocaine jaw, you know.
Cocaine jaw?
You not heard cocaine jaw?
Apparently not.
Yeah, you start really like clenching really hard and like grinding away at it a little bit. Cocaine jaw, you know, doing the splits. That's the number one sign of cocaine abuse.
Wait a minute.
No, they don't tell you that in Dare.
They don't.
No.
I feel lied to. Okay, you exploded.
You know, as they say, like, weed gives you the munchies. Cocaine makes you want to do the full splits.
Oh, fascinating. Absolutely fascinating. Is you up here? You are up here. Great.
These days we call that Adderall teeth. Adderall makes you like clench your jaw and all that stuff.
No. No.
You ever see a Coke nail? Yeah, the first time I saw a Coke nail was in Willy Wonka. Grandpa Joe.
That's right.
God.
Grandpa Joe.
Yep, that's what got him out of bed.
It's got to be something.
Yep. Golden ticket and the line.
Adderall makes me clench my jaw? You might want to check with your doctor about that. I don't believe that is a known side effect. It is an appetite suppressant. It is abused as an appetite suppressant. But I don't believe it's supposed to make you clench your jaw. Though, you know, I could be wrong. I guess it affects everybody differently.
Well, yeah, either your doctor or your dentist. You might have bruxism.
Talk to your doctor.
Might, if you take it too much and you don't have ADD, oh, that'll do you.
That could be. Now we're talking. Now that's the ticket.
Take as prescribed,
absolutely. Okay. We got some souls to cash in here. I don't think I have the stones to upgrade my weapon, but we're pretty good. What do I get?
I don't do any of the fun drugs anymore now that I'm a boring dad. Oh, I do. The amount of pills that I pop nowadays, like vitamin C, magnesium, vitamin K for absorption.
Yep.
Fish pills. Oh, my God.
Oh, so many fish pills.
Fish pill, yeah.
So many fish pills.
The fun starts as you get older. Have I been counting Jack's debts? Yep, right there. We're up to seven. So
seven?
Mostly grabbing. Yeah.
Ugh. Seven. Seven feels like too many.
Hmm.
I'm sorry, everyone. I feel like I've let you down. We're at 7. But, you know, we're getting a good number of bosses. I'm feeling very good about the number of bosses that we are handling, so. So, I'm happy.
You got one of those little daily pill boxes? Somewhere. I lost it. I had a weak one.
Oh, Monday Tuesday? Sunday.
Yeah. I don't know where I put it. I wanted to get a big one, but I figured I could just get a tackle box. A lot cheaper.
Yeah, you could.
For all these pills that I'd be taking.
You know, I take a daily vitamin, a little Adderall here or there, prescribed, of course. Because I'm a square.
So. No.
Oh yeah, I'm a big square.
That's the new edge, don't you know?
Square's the new edge.
Oh yeah. I hear Rod Dog in life. Like that's crazy. Who is it? Tom Waits. Realities for people who can't handle drugs.
Ooh, I like it. Oh crap! I think I don't have. I don't have a way to light the torches down there. And so I either need to... I need a butterfly.
Yeah.
Frost, I need a butterfly.
Butterfly? We'll go to the meadows, Jack.
Butterfly in the sky.
Oh.
I can fly twice as high. Let's take a look. It's in a book. Okay, let's see. Does this biddy have a butterfly? She dunna.
Does Frost spend substantial time in the UK? I feel like I hear British style of affectations in his voice. There's like 3 accents fighting for supremacy in my mouth at all times. Whichever it might be.
We'll take it.
Whichever it might be, yeah.
We'll take it. You know, we appreciate you wherever your accent is from.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, come back here.
As far as, like, the influence there, a lot of, a good, like, 6 years of my upbringing, it was just, European, what was it? European media, because I was doing voiceover work, and they wanted that RP.
Oh.
Yeah, and, I get now it's kind of frowned upon to go for accents that aren't yours, right? But at the time, no one knew that I wasn't, yeah. And so, yeah, that'll do you.
So what accent were you doing?
It was just mine. I was just going in with whatever, because this was like 2011, 2013. Nowadays, it's very common to go, here's what I'm looking for and who I want.
Mm-hmm.
Then it wasn't so much. Granted, these weren't like high productions or anything. They were just like, go do an accent, and that would be super proper. Yeah,
go do an accent.
And I ended up with a lot of European studios and productions, and how I got into games as well with like people from New Zealand, and it was that ambiguous accent that made them go, yeah, let's have that.
Oh, okay, sure.
I was like, cool,
sure. White accents don't count.
White accents don't count.
in general, especially if you are a white performer, pointing to myself. Yeah, like I can do an Italian accent. No one's going to call foul on that. I can do a German accent. No one's going to call foul on that. But depending on the accent,
yeah.
We have tricks at the improv theater. Because, you know, we'll ask for that every once in a while. We'll have games in which we do a little scene, and then we replay that scene. But now you're all high school cliques, right? Now you all have an accent. And so, you know, some refs use selective deafness. Give me some accents, or give me European accents. Or you can just ask for American accents, and that's okay, too. You can do whatever you want. Who sells, chat? Who sells butterflies? Is there someone that says... Oh, maybe this lady sells butterflies. Mamma mia. Here we go again.
Did you sound American to them? I don't know. It was like... It was just whoever's ears it were. They either think I was the most American person they'd ever heard, or the most European. Even Yahtzee, when he met me, he says, "Are you, like, did you spend time in Europe? Or are you from Ireland?" Always saying I sounded like Terry Wogan, and it just comes and goes. Honestly, a lot of it just comes down to what I've been watching. I've been watching Blackadder recently.
Sure.
Yeah. That intermingling with Justified. So you've got, you have English RP, and then you have this Kentucky drawl.
I think that's a good combination. We like it.
Yeah.
We like it. Maybe there's a butterfly over here. What do we think, chat?
Oh, Manicito. Yeah, on top of being Mexican and being fluent in Spanish. Mm-hmm. You're just like, well, he's all over the place.
Yeah. And that's great. You bring a that's a lot of boxes to dark troaches. That's a lot of boxes to potentially check off of, like, oh, this is what we need. Oh, you can do that. Oh, you can do that. Oh, you can do that. Great.
Like, fantastic. Now again, but this time Swedish. Wait, this is a very strange role, and now it's not AI, it's just me trapped in a box.
But now Swedish. Damn it. No one is telling me where they sell butterflies. I'm disappointed in all of you.
Because you're the knowledgeable one here. They would have bullied Nick for it. But you've intimidated the chat.
That's fair. I just want a butterfly. Where can I get a butterfly?
Weaponsmith Ornifex. Who's that? 600 souls.
Yeah, that's the bird. That's way late game. That's the bird. Where do I pick up a butterfly? I need a butterfly if I'm going to fight the Lost Sinner. Because I don't.
What do you need it for?
Well, because you need something to light the torches with. And so you need to have your torch lit to light the torches.
Can't you light it at the bonfire?
You can light it at the bonfire, but in order to get to it, like, the it's a water-filled area and a large enemy is in the way. So theoretically, okay. I could go through the area, clear out all of the enemies, including the large enemy and the explodey enemies.
Right.
Or I could just fucking light a butterfly. I could just run past all that bullshit and light a butterfly.
How can I farm it? War Master's Shack? Are we anywhere near that? Eastern Tableland, if any of those ring a bell.
I don't think any of those are going to help me.
Tragic.
We're in No Man's Wharf now, and I guess we'll see.
No Man's Wharf? Yeah. One on a corpse behind two large pots in a house in No Man's Wharf. The house is near the large ship after you have rung the bell.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we got
time. There's one in the area.
We got time.
Yeah. Sexy single butterflies in this area.
They're looking for me?
I know, it is I. I'm the sexy single.
Oh, okay, I'll take that.
You'll indulge one more question about your voice as a fellow gravel voice haver. Do people also ask you if you smoke? People assume it's cigarettes, whiskey, any of that kind of stuff. I'm not sure where it comes from. Because I don't think voice, I have a nice, I call it a nice brass. It's textured. It's not the note, it's that hint of a roughness to it.
Yeah. You're saying you're not sure where your rasp is coming from?
Yeah, I don't know what made it, you know?
Oh,
I don't
sure.
think, as a kid, I didn't have that. I had a deep voice, couldn't do anything with it, and it wasn't until that gravel came through that it became more defined, I guess. I don't know where that comes from.
Interesting.
Catch some rare disease when you were young?
Now that's personal.
Yes. A raw egg in the morning. Yeah.
Are you raw egging?
Oh, the new. A whole onion. Snake in the Garden, 2-year-old Jack. Has your wife, kids seen Adventures Nigh? Do they like it?
They don't watch regularly. They see me work on it every once in a while. And I've shown them clips and I've shown them episodes. They're, you know, not impressed. No, just because they know, like, I work on it, it's probably really hard for them to, like, watch me play a game, if that makes any sense.
Right, all right.
I play D&D with my wife, and so she's like, no, I get enough of that. I don't need to watch you play with other people.
We have to make it into an anime, and then a live action again.
Oh, my God. Then my kids would be all over it.
TSP, $10. Gotta head off before the end of the stream. So here's an early tip for some nice work. Oh, look at that. You got a nice tip for your crazy Dark Souls 2 run here.
You know, we're doing okay, I think.
The boss is down.
Ooh. I feel like we're doing all right so far. We got a... I'm in a weird area now. We rung the bell to get the ship in, so we got that going for us. Oh.
If your family thinks you're cool, you're doing it wrong.
No, it's like, you know, my younger ones, yeah, they don't care. Like, they don't care about that, my younger ones. My younger ones, a.k.a. my children.
As opposed to my older children. Older than me. Sometimes children can adopt parents.
That's true. But like, you know, I also like, I play D&D with my youngest son. We have a group with him and a friend and their kids. And so like, they're not interested in hearing me play with other people. They just want to play.
Well, they're jealous. Yeah.
Oh, 100%.
Dad's giving other people attention now.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. Your weigh-ins, your burns. Yeah.
That's exactly what it is. But also, like, they probably, you know, hear me complain about it. Like, oh, I got to do this and do this and do this. So, like, they don't, you know, they don't want to see the other side of it.
I'd have everyone line up and clap for me. Like, yep, this is why you can all afford nice clothes and toys. I paid for that with this.
basically. Line up and clap for me. Everyone, please line up and clap for me.
Will you be adding season 2 of Adventures Nigh to Spotify?
We actually, like, we just literally yesterday had a meeting about that very thing. And the answer is we are adding it to... We are going to try to add Adventures Nigh, all of it, to an audio-only format as soon as possible. That's something I've said from the very beginning. And I assumed it was happening, I'll be honest with you. I did not know that it wasn't on these platforms. So the answer is yes, it will be happening.
There you go. Yeah, exactly, speak. Just like Jeb. Please clap.
Please clap. This is the hard thing, the hard thing I have a hard time selling is clothes. Because it's like, oh, what if I need that outfit? But I know I won't. I know I won't need any of this.
You're playing a naked man. What's a naked man need with clothes?
Just in case I need clothes. I know some things I can sell. What do you sell, Goblin? Ooh, increased poise? Yes, let's buy that. Goblin deal.
No, yep, that's me, Sideburns. I don't know about anyone else, but I never vendor anything unless I have a dupe, he says. Yep.
Oh, well...
If I have a dupe, I'll sell it, but I always keep one.
Fair. I think that's fair. Like, this is one of those situations where it's like, I know the weapons I'm using, so there's no stopping me. I'm okay selling every other weapon. I'm going to keep the shields, because... I might want a shield at one point. Excuse you, Dark Souls.
Oh,
I did not want you to lock onto that.
That's him. It's Dark Souls.
I wanted to lock onto the enemy that was in front of me, and it locked onto, like, a dog down the block. Dark Souls.
Like that one. You meant that one. Yeah.
That's definitely the one he wanted, right over there. All right. Are you in this house? Excuse me.
That's why I reach every boss with 99 elixirs, because you never know. I don't hoard so much here. If anything, I probably should hold on to some things. I'm a hoarder in, like, Skyrim. Oh, the amount of potions I have. Oh.
That's a death.
Eight. Oh, there we go.
And that was hubris. You can, you know, chalk that up to hubris. I am... I was playing a little laissez-faire, and that was 100% my fault.
Oh, yeah. A little fast and loose.
Little cavalier. Oh, these guys, they're going down so fast. I don't need to heal. I did. And that's the beauty. That's the beauty of the Dark Souls formula, is even when you know what you're doing and you're overpowered, you can still fuck up.
It still humbles, yeah? Uh-huh. Oh. Out of curiosity, are there Souls-likes that are designed towards fighting multiple enemies? Define Souls-likes. And I might have an answer. Causes of death in Dark Souls. Hubris, gravity.
Yep. Sometimes that's the same thing. Hubris and gravity. Excuse you, Dark Souls. Excuse you, Dark Souls. Damn it.
Like, yeah, I've played a few Souls-likes that at least they were trying to go for a big crowd control type of fighting style, but it's odd. It just sort of becomes this hack and slash game where you can't get hit once. It's a rough balance. Yeah.
Like, I would definitely argue that, like, one of the core Souls experience is fighting crowds, is crowd management.
Right.
You know, like, that's when the game turns real, is when you do have to deal with a crowd of enemies and you realize that you are ill-equipped to do so.
Yeah.
So.
Or you get caught in a corner or something.
Right.
A strange rock is like, oh, God, there's 20 people right behind me.
They're right behind me, aren't they?
Oh, I can breathe them. I can feel their breathing. Guys, yeah, like, fighting multiple enemies, maybe. Fleeing from hordes of enemies, definitely.
Oh, yeah. And, like, it's that, like, picking and choosing your battles that is kind of the at the core of the Dark Souls experience. So I don't think we would like it if we had to fight multiple enemies all the time in Dark Souls. Oh, crap, I don't want to die again. Then let's go to the boss. I don't know where... Fuck, fuck, fuck. I don't know where these butterflies are, so we're going to the boss.
Oh. Wow.
Are they up here? Is this where they are? I don't know what's going on. I don't know. Let's go to the boss.
The house is near the large ship after you've rung the bell. Did you ring a bell?
Yeah, I'm in the large ship.
There's a house somewhere near there with butterflies in it.
I'm sure there is. We'll deal with it after we beat the boss.
Sideburn saying, the house with the green pot. Pot house.
Ow. Ow. Okay, boss is dead.
First try. Look at that. Easy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, very, very easy.
Yeah, we didn't need it.
We didn't need it. This is another boss weapon that I always contemplate using, as you can get... Ooh, oh, they are just waiting for me. Well, let's leave. You can get the Flexile Sentries like barbed club, which is so badass. But, you know, you got a regular club. What do you need anything else? You got a regular club.
You take this club all the way to the end game.
I could.
Oh.
I could take this club all the way to the end game. But there's a club that I like better. Or there's a club that has slightly better stats, and it's just the reinforced club. But if that's how we want to meme run this one, and I just use the club and Unga Bunga it all the way to the end, I'm cool with that.
This game is broken. Oh. This man's broken.
This man is broken. How late do you feel like going, Frost?
Oh, as far as you'd like. I cleared the schedule for this.
Oh, shit, yeah. Then we'll get a little bit more done.
Lovely.
We'll get a little bit more done. We got time. We got time to, if as long as y'all are okay hanging out, chat.
Yeah, chat. You got somewhere to be?
You tell us.
What are you doing? On a Tuesday? You're
gonna
go out.
What's going on a Tuesday?
Clubbing at 5 PM? Clubs aren't even open yet.
The clubs aren't, first of all, chat, the clubs aren't even open. So who are you fooling? Not us.
Go up early and ask for a chicken dinner at the bar.
Hell yeah, chicken dinner. You know what that is. That's winner, winner right there. Chicken dinner. Where are we going? Where are we going? Here's where we're going. I love that I was like, oh, man, I'll just check this area for a butterfly. And, you know, you just end up... beating another boss. And
no, I'm sorry. Just get out of my way.
I'll just beat another boss.
I can't find this butterfly. Killed a man for it.
I just want a butterfly. I'm sure somewhere around here there's a butterfly.
Sure, keep it going. We don't have recap. Frost, Jack, do a quick recap before end of stream. Sure. What you been watching, Jack?
Well, we already did that. We talked about One Piece and how much I'm genuinely enjoying it. I did. I have a friend who's very into One Piece who bullied me into picking up the manga.
Oh, it's getting serious.
Yeah, well, and you know, it's just like I'm okay, you know, expanding my horizons a little bit. And I was okay, I'll check out the manga. And I got a few like books, you know, like issues into the manga.
Right.
And already I'm seeing like some of the positive things that the live action remake has done as far as like characterizations and story arcs, where it's like, oh man, they really went in depth on Luffy's like relationship with his adopted pirate father.
Yeah.
In the live action remake, whereas in the manga, it's like two panels.
yeah, no, that's pretty common.
Oh, right. And so it's just like, oh, well, I'm really happy that they fleshed this out more because it's way more impactful.
The thing with it is that it's very surface level at the start, but they kind of, well, I guess it's kind of like in D&D, how it's like, okay, it's your turn now to have the defining arc. And then it's your turn to have the defining arc on the next one, you know?
Sure.
That's kind of what they do here, whereas in the live action they went, we don't know how far we're going to go, so let's go ahead and take some of those things now, you know, flesh it out now.
Yeah.
We might not make it this season, whatever.
Because we just might. No, well, and I think that's part of the joy of a... you're not a hidden wall. That's part of the joy of a... oh my God, adaptation is like, oh, we know later on this relationship is really important, so we're going to do what we can to set it up now.
Oh, there you go.
So,
Matthew saying, mind asking Jack where they shot Adventure is Nigh? I'm wondering if it was the RLM studio.
It was not. I say it during the episodes. So I do wonder if you've watched the episodes. We shot it here in Milwaukee at Comedy Sports, which is the theater that I do improv at. So one, get good, scrub, you know, watch the thing. You know, luckily I have a very good relationship with the people over at Comedy Sports, and they were kind enough to allow us to use some space. We found a little side space where we could set up all of our cameras and stuff. I don't want to fight the pursuer yet, so we're going to homeward bone out of here.
There you go.
So, yeah, that's where we shot at Comedy Sports. Just that easy. Which, again, no. I say during the episodes. But did I have any more stories? I don't have any more stories to say about that because I can't get into too many spoilery things. You were so close to a butterfly. Where's a butterfly?
Some house near there type thing. I missed that. Sorry, I only caught one. Great show. Don't call me a scrub chump.
No, that's fair. That's fair. Obviously joking. But, yeah, no, we didn't want to, you know, for shooting, we shot 2 episodes a day.
Wow.
And we shot 5 days. And, like, you know, setting up cameras, shooting, setting up all of the computers, everything. It was a full day of shooting. And so there was no way we could take that time away from Red Letter Media's production schedule. At least I didn't think we could take that time away from Red Letter Media's production schedule. No. Sure. I have souls. I should go level up before I fuck around.
Yeah. Oh, is that Nick? I'm better at Dark Souls than Jackie says. We're a ways in now, Nick, with 8 deaths total. I don't know how that feels from Iceland.
So 8 deaths and 5 bosses killed.
Yep.
Yeah.
Some optional.
I'm feeling pretty comfortable with where I am, Nick. Pretty darn comfortable.
No, but two shows or 2 episodes a day.
Each episode was about 2.5 hours of actual filming time, and then it's, you know, an hour plus to set up and tear down. So yeah, it was a ridiculous schedule. While it would have been really nice to have that studio space, there's no possible... You all would have been so upset at me if we took that time away from the RLM production schedule. You would have been so pissed.
Yep. Can't have it both ways.
Yeah. So...
Really not good enough. 0 deaths.
Zero deaths. Oh, fuck. That's right. I wanted a butterfly. Yeah, someone tell. Oh, that's right. No Man's Wharf. Okay.
Yeah, you're gonna kill the last boss, and it's like still couldn't find that butterfly.
God damn, need a goddamn butterfly.
Get it. Fantastic. So, live action. Anything else you've been watching?
Ooh, what? What else have I been watching? No. I guess the only other thing I've been doing is I've been dipping my fingers a little bit into that Immortals of Averon game.
Avium,
the, you know, magic shoot.
It just closed down, right?
The one that just fired all of their staff. Yes. Yep.
You're playing a corpse, apparently. Yeah. How is that? How's that holding up?
You know what? I think it's pretty okay. Like, it's kind of exactly what I expected. Where it's like, okay, it's a first-person shooter, but you're using magic bullshit.
Right.
And, yeah, that's what it is.
And you chose to release it a stacked year, apparently.
Oh, right? Well, it's also like, what kind of expectations did you have for this game that you've fired half of your staff? Like, come on.
That is like, all right, no one gave me back the money that was promised. Half of you are gone. It's like, how much were you expecting? It's like, I made merch, t-shirts, toys. I put my house on this. TJ Carr, $5. Jack's character looks like the monster from Amnesia Dark Descent. I never got a good look at him.
Does he?
I don't know.
Here's my character.
I don't think so.
Oh, okay. Well, we'll see. We'll see. I never played Amnesia at the Dark Descent. Oh, well, there's a fragment branch of yore. Isn't there? There it is.
Duckfield 5 Canadian. Jack, have you ever seen the 90s comedy called The Stoned Age?
The Stoned Age.
The Stoned Age.
I don't believe I have seen The Stoned Age.
Cavemen and the weed? What is this?
Oh, was that the one with Ringo Starr?
Let's have a looky.
Because there was a caveman comedy with Ringo Starr, and I want to say they got high. but I don't know if that's it.
No. These are actually not cavemen. What? The cover says better than Dazed and Confused. Well, now I have to.
Now I have to.
It's following two long-haired stoners who spend a night touring the suburbs of Los Angeles looking for alcohol parties and young women. This is super bad before super bad.
Ooh, Flame Butterfly. Thank you. Okay. Got it. It's the
best stoner comedy of all time. Well, I don't know about this.
Come on. Okay. First of all, now. Come on.
I feel like some of these stoner comedies haven't aged well since decriminalization. I feel like the taboo's gone, so now it's not nearly as funny anymore.
You know, I think, like, if you look at something like, I'm going to forget. What was the Dave Chappelle stoner comedy?
Half-Baked.
You know, you look at Half-Baked, they were also very, like, critical of stoner culture, which I think really helped make sure that was like, oh, like, this is a stoner comedy, but, like, we're realistic about how awful we are as people. I say that as a former stoner. Like, yeah, we were, you know, people who are just, like, only into stoner culture, come on, take a look inside. That's what are we were talking about that the other day on the Zelda stream on Thursday, about just like if you define yourself by too narrow a spectrum, that's when you turn into a real big dickhead.
So you gotta have multiple hobbies. Multiple stoner hobbies. Gamer, rock climbing guy. Ooh. You know.
Oh, you're a stoner gamer rock climber. You know what? You have things to talk about other than being a stoner.
You got two things.
You got two more things. You got two whole things.
And that third one just kind of takes him out of left field.
Yeah, and that's okay.
420 isn't a personality. Oh,
I know too many people whom that is. That's what they got.
Right. Yeah, George Lucas weed makes me paranoid. That's funny.
Yeah, that was one of the big reasons why I stopped smoking so much, was it isolated me. It made me very, very paranoid. And so, like, people would come over. I was, like, renting a house with some friends who were also stoners. Right. And people would come over, and, you know, I would get high, and then I'd go to... I was living in, like, a basement room of this house that we rented. Mm-hmm. And I would just stay in my basement house, in the basement, by myself. Occasionally coming upstairs for a little bit of pot, and then that was my life, and it was kind of miserable.
Like a cryptid of sorts.
Oh yeah, yeah. Well, and
you got cookies, milk, and a joint.
That's all I needed. Cookies, milk, and a joint, and Metal Gear Solid.
Oh.
Which I'm sure did not help the paranoia at all.
Yeah, yeah. And I was like, okay, here we go. We're talking psyops now. The government can't be trusted. You're right.
You're right. Oh, yeah. And so I think that was, like, part of the issue was Metal Gear Solid.
Right. I like this. Paranoia is just the world telling you to be a better person.
Ooh,
maybe.
Ooh, dang. All right. Maybe. I'm going to try to be a coward and run past this Flexile Sentry. We'll see if it works.
I believe in it. What's it here? I tried it just to see what it was like.
Sure.
And the problem was it was too expensive. For some reason, it just didn't hit my body that well.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I went, if I want any sort of relationship with this, it is costly, and I don't care for that. So, you know, once a year, maybe twice a year at most, but even then, it's just like, okay. it'll last maybe an hour or two.
Sure.
And I don't kid yourself. I have tried, but I was like, come on, surely. There's got to be a wall somewhere.
Oh, my God. If there is a flame butterfly right here, by the way. Fun. Oh, there's not. Okay, good.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah. That would have genuinely upset me. Going around finding flame butterflies. You know, and it's like, if that's your thing, like, do that. Like, have fun. If you can, like, you know, this is not a condemnation of people who smoke or whatever.
Mm.
It absolutely is a condemnation of anyone who turns it into their personality.
Yeah. But and that's for anything.
That's for anything.
Don't let any one thing be your personality.
Oh, man.
Like Michael Jordan, all he talks about is basketball. I get it. You were kind of good. I get it.
Son of a bitch again?
Yeah.
All right. Set a light. Set a light. So Nick, this is another, if you're still watching, this is another way you can do this fight.
Yep.
If you get certain things first and, you know, have a torch, you can set these alight, and then the arena is all lit up so that you can see the battle. Theoretically, yeah, they want you to fight everything that's in that little room first.
Right.
But, you know, you don't have to. Oh, I just threw a bomb. I don't know if
Nick's still here. Probably hard to hear over the shower that he's crying in right now.
Oh, Nick, it's okay.
He did have his way, though. He just turned the gamma up. Oh, yeah, that works.
Just, this, you know what? This is another great boss design. This is a beautiful boss. Hands bound, still sword fighting. Still, you know, no match for my mighty hunk of wood.
That you got from the start of the level.
Yep.
Oh, so this is what it's supposed to look like. Okay. Right.
You know, they give you options. Where it's like, if you want to do this fight, you can. There is an easier way to do it. Oh, wait. Hubris.
Oh.
Might die. We'll see. Ooh, might die. Don't die. Ooh, died. Dang it. Ooh, that one we got very close.
Yeah, right down to it. I was like,
very, very close. I couldn't figure out the rolls for that one where I felt like I was rolling. I felt like I was rolling correctly, but the game didn't feel the same. Oh, well. That's fine. Yeah. We got very close. And I'm going to be comfortable with that.
Well, it could be more wrong. Michael Jordan talks nonstop about golf is true love. That is an interesting one. Where the people who are obsessed with basketball don't realize that even Michael Jordan himself has other interests.
Right?
It's like, wow.
He gave up to play baseball.
Did. He was in Space Jam, bro.
He was in Space Jam. Have you been in Space Jam? I don't think so.
LeBron has. They've got more to talk about now. Bill Murray was. Google App member for 11 months early access. Thank you. New character name, Hugh Briss.
Ooh, that's a good one.
Clever. I think that was because of gambling. Well, who hasn't, you know, bet the house, lost, and had to be in a movie you weren't supposed to be in? Nicolas Cage understands.
Right? And it's like, I'll give this one more try. If I die again, I might put on some armor. Because, you know, the game probably wants you to wear armor at this point.
I don't know of anyone who watched Space Jam 2. Did you watch Space Jam 2?
Hell yeah, I watched Space Jam 2.
Oh, okay. Well, what are your feels on it?
I mean, oh, it's very, very bad. It's like, It is an incredibly bad movie. Even by the standards of Space Jam, it is an incredibly bad movie.
Who do they have now? Like, I get it. You got the big superstar, but where's DeVito? Where's your Murray?
Right? Does anyone care about Looney Tunes? At this point, like, do kids care about Looney Tunes? I don't think they do.
I do. I'm there with Bugs Bunny. I like say the line.
Say the
bit. Say it.
Oh no! Oh, yeah, got me again. Got me again.
He's out here. Like, put a shirt on, you hussy.
I know. It's one of those bosses with a very unusual moveset, as far as I'm concerned. Mm-hmm. And so it's just taking me a little bit to find that rhythm, but that's okay. We're going to stream a little longer. I'm going to see if I can get a couple more bosses done before we end, because we got time. We got time to stream. We got to
say something, make a statement.
We got to make a statement. I'm also, doing a little procrastinating of editing. Editing the next Adventures Nigh. I'm in the hard part of editing, which is like listening to my own mistakes.
Right.
Which, you know, it happens. And a lot of right now, the next episode of Adventures Nigh, we filmed for an absurdly long amount of time. Such a long amount of time that it's going to be either like a bear of an edit, or we have to split it into two episodes because we filmed for so long. And during the entirety of filming, I can hear myself. Oh, look at this. Look at this happy little fellow. Look how he fell.
Oh,
praise the sun, my friend.
Oh.
During the entirety of the filming, I can hear myself turn to Omar and say, "Don't worry. There's plenty to cut. We're fine. We're fine on time. We're fine on time." I was so wrong.
I lied to this man.
Past Jack lied to Omar and future Jack. And that's okay.
Pure Pyro wants to know, do you use Premiere Pro for editing? What do you use for editing?
I do. I do use Premiere Pro. For a while, I was switched over to DaVinci Resolve, which I still think is a phenomenal program. DaVinci is a great editing software, great compositing software, really good audio software. It's a kind of an all-in-one spiel, and it's a one-time purchase. You buy it once, you own it forever. The issue is when you work in teams. We have editing teams now, and so once I started working with Omar editing stuff, he would have to spend extra time to make sure I could open up projects in Resolve, and I just felt incredibly bad about it. I've switched back to the Adobe suite, and now we are utilizing the entirety of the Adobe suite. After Effects, Photoshop. Oh my God, Lost Sinner. You hit like a dump truck, my friend.
We're not sponsored by Adobe, by the way.
No, I think their prices are ridiculous. I think, like, you know, they were one of the first professional softwares that went monthly subscription, and I hate it.
Yep.
Ouch.
This hasn't convinced me to buy Adobe Premiere. Well, if that didn't convince you, this might. I also used a completely different thing, and I didn't swap to Adobe until I had coworkers that I had to have the same.
Yep.
I think the reason most of us use Adobe is because the work.
Well, and their collaboration tools are top-notch. That's the positive thing you can say about Adobe. Is like, fuck you.
Lost Sinner, you should not have been able to hit me. And one. All right, no hubris. No hubris. There we go. Okay. There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Did it. That's the most positive thing you say about Adobe is fuck you. Right. The most positive thing you can say is like their collaboration stuff and like the interworkings between their compositor, After Effects, and their editor, Premiere, and their audio software, Audition, is flawless and seamless and wonderful. And we are utilizing a lot of their post-production workflow for Adventures Nigh to its highest degree. But they also charge you every single month for something you don't own. Before, you bought Premiere or Final Cut or whatever it was, and you owned that. You could run that for as long as you live and your computer lives. Now you can't. And that sucks.
Yep. So you have to, you have to cancel once a year. To get that 50% off, and that's the real price.
Right?
We got Galden with the $5. Well fought. That guy's final sin was against the hitboxes.
He was that person, or she, I believe it's a she, was very far away from me and continued to hit me. So I'm going to call bull hockey on a couple of that. But it's fine.
That's just karma for the dragon rider, no? She knew. They're all aware. Here comes the mighty cheese.
That dragon rider cheese. Oh, baby, man. That gets you through so much early game, getting all of those levels right away. Just, you know.
How many levels did that get you right off the bat?
I actually don't know, because I also started as lowly, which means you're starting at level one. I'm glad to see you safe. So I actually don't know. Someone in chat will need to look through and go through our video on demand.
There you go.
Let me buy some shit.
Would it be better if they also had something like Microsoft, where they release a previous year bundle for a few hundred every year?
Well,
I have a hard time picturing that because I don't know what Microsoft does.
I also don't know what Microsoft does, so.
All right, so I'll send her down. Who's the next boss?
Oh, I don't want to buy five of these. Who is the next boss? That's a good question. Sinner's down. So I guess the next boss is we have to go through the wharf. Oh, no, we already went through the wharf. Oh, you know what we can do? Here's something fun we can do. We can go to a boss that I believe Nick skipped.
You're going to have to be a little more specific, sure. The Rotten?
Oh, we can go to the Shaded Woods, maybe. Because I got another Fragrant Branch of Yore. Or do we go and try to do the Chariot? I think I can go do the Chariot. What do we think, chat? Hold on. Let's see if I can do the chariot real quick.
We've got some chariot. Okay. Chariot question mark. And they gave you 16 levels, the Dragon Rider did.
Boom.
Juicy.
Oh, yeah. We can go this way. Great. Yes, fine. Move path.
Chariot. Nick didn't do the chariot, so you do it.
Okay. That's a good... Okay. That's what we'll do. We'll do the chariot next. That's a fun fight. The fun thing about this one is... The fight is pretty fun and interesting. This is, without a doubt, the worst run back of any Souls game, bar none.
Oh?
This is it. This is it. This is the worst. Oh, shit, I forgot to level up after I ate that soul. I bought some gear. Actually, we'll see if my drip
once we get to the next bonfire, we'll see if I can wear my new drip, my bling, my fashion souls.
Fashions.
I love fashion souls.
It gives me poison resistance.
We're not going to talk to you. You're full of shit. All right.
Yeah, have you played the DLC? That was a question earlier.
Yes. Souls?
Okay.
I have played the DLC. I do not enjoy the DLC, and I don't plan on playing the DLC ever again.
Oh, God.
I think FromSoft has a bad habit of making their DLC only for the hardest core of player. And I don't think it's as interesting or as fun as the rest of the game so far. I think, like, Dark Souls 3 had some really interesting DLC. The DLC for Dark Souls 1, I mean, it, like, fucking that Sanctuary Beast alone is so fucking tough. Fucking hell.
Are you saying that you are not a good player, Jack?
That is exactly what I'm saying. It was that Nick that said that.
No, that was Sideburns.
Oh. That is exactly what I'm saying. I am not a good player and not good at the game. No, I just don't think it's fun. I don't think it's fun, and I think they have a bad habit of making the DLC small and difficult.
Oh, why'd you say it would take Nick so long then?
Nick has a ridiculous amount of things to do.
Ah, I see.
Because Nick ended up at the castle, right? He just beat the Mirror Knight, I believe, was the last thing he did.
I think so. I think we got lost again.
Yeah, he got lost again after beating the Mirror Knight. He has a ridiculous amount of things to do left. He's maybe 2/3 of the way through the game.
Okay.
So I don't know if, like, a ridiculous amount, but he has several more hours to go. Which is really funny.
That is assuming that we don't get lost. Yeah.
There are two rat bosses in the game. There is the Royal Rat Revenants and the Royal Rat Vanguard, which I think is, like, actually a dog, but counts as a giant rat. I forget how. I just popped all those souls and then didn't level up.
Oh, this is dangerous out here.
Can you believe that? Can you believe I did that?
That gives me more paranoia than anything. Oh my god.
Right? I know, I didn't level up. I popped all my souls and didn't level up. Right, here we go. Now we're getting there. So, Frost.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about yourself.
About me?
Tell me about you. What can you tell me about you? Tell me about early gamer Frost.
My social is... Oh, it's there. Early gamer Frost. It's interesting because I am now... Because men will do anything but go to therapy, besides going to therapy.
Absolutely.
I'm now realizing how influential that was on my gaming preference now, because my first games were... immigrant, did not know English. Mm-hmm. So my favorite games were the ones that could sort of just explain themselves without relying so much on language.
Ooh, yeah. All right.
And so that, if you were to ask me, tell me about young Gamer Frost, I like very emotive, very colorful games.
Okay.
Very, very, tell their story through pantomiming or have a nice way of framing their objectives, I suppose, getting you through it.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe that's where that comes from, where I go, my God, I don't think I've loved a map so much as, like, Dark Souls 1's map.
Yeah.
Where it goes, you could probably get through that without language.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, yeah.
And so, yeah, I don't know. It is that thing as a child. Oh, not knowing language was the first thing. But then I was also a very active child. I would read books and I would... watch films, but I also go outside and play. I would touch grass, as the kids say, uh-huh, back in those days. See, now it's a rare commodity, this grass you speak of.
What is this grass you speak
what
of?
What is this grass? It hasn't been grass since the scorching. and so I guess I didn't get back into games until I was well into high school. At that point, I was just sort of like a normal gamer dude. Yeah, you know, next card, let's try this out. Until Freak Lightning Storm fried the Ethernet port on my Xbox 360.
Oh. So,
no more multiplayer for you, it says. And friend said, you like shooters, try Bioshock. I was like, all right. That was the first one that made me go, all right, these games have, like, they can have some proper story to them. Sure, why not?
Sure, sure.
And that stuck with me, but I never pursued it until Bastion. Bastion was the first non-shooter indie game that made me go, okay, this balance between narrative and gameplay is something that is really, really addictive.
Yeah,
and I think that there it goes. That was the storm that just set me off into, all right, let's try finding more games. Sure, why not?
Ooh, I like it.
I love it. Bastion was great. Oh, God, I've been a Super Giant Games fan forever. I don't love every game they play. I just love the way they try. Transistor? It was like turn-based coding? What
yeah,
am I thinking?
Yeah.
What am I thinking? I love it, but it wasn't for me.
I enjoy the phrase. I love the way they try.
Yeah, it's almost bittersweet with like Hades 2. I'm not saying they're not trying. I'm sure they're putting their heart into it.
Yeah.
But each game they did was so different, so similar but so different. And now it's like, okay, we're just doing this again. Almost makes you sad. In a time where a lot of people are playing it a little too safe, you know.
Oh, it's sure,
like,
sure. Oh,
yeah, you guys were the ones that were just really going kind of wacky with it. And the dude who eats pianos, $5. This stream was better than working on data pipelines, so wanted to appreciate you with money. Also want to meet the Halloween stream goal. That's right. With all these donos, we're going to give Nick, the person with heart problems, a heart attack.
Yay! Wait, what? Yeah.
I'm sorry. No, it's the Halloween stream series where he gets to play spooky games.
Oh, okay. We like spooky games.
Why is Jack wearing clothes as a fungus?
I've updated my drip here. Like, I still am shirtless.
Yeah, it's cold in here.
But you know, it's we are moving up. We are leveling up in the game, and so every once in a while, then you gotta upgrade your character. I guess I don't need to do this. I just think it's fun.
Yeah, we grow up. We mature. We put on clothes.
We grow.
That's what we do. That's a creepy song. Wait, what song?
We grow up. We mature. We put on clothes. That song. You know, the classic.
Yeah, of course. How about for you, Jack? Because you have a reputation for having your taste.
Yeah.
Not your strange taste, not your bad or good taste. Jack's taste. Where does this come from?
Where does my taste come from? Right? Like, I don't know. I like what I like is where it comes from. I like what I like. And, oh, fuck. Oh, don't die. Oh, I died. Oh, crap.
No. Oh, gravity. There we go.
Classic gravity. Technically gravity, but really someone knocked me off. No, it probably comes from being severely dyslexic. That's my gamer backstory. Is I hate reading, and reading is really slow and tedious for me.
Right.
And so the less a game makes me read, actually probably very similar to you. The less a game makes me read, the more I enjoy it. Can you tell me a story just with the visuals and the gameplay? Can I understand what's going on through just gameplay?
See, mine comes like similar in that vein, because I don't like reading in games as well. That's because I was absolutely a fiend for books as a kid. I was cleaning out libraries. Mm. That's how much I was reading.
Oh, wow.
And if a book... And not a book. If a game tries that, I go, I could, this could have been a book. This could have been So games, I can really lean into the thing that makes them different from, you know, the written mediums, if you will.
Yeah.
they just stand out to me. Yeah, but you love D&D, says Reaper's Grim. You ain't got to read for that. That's Jackson improvising the whole time.
Right? Yeah, most of my D&D, like, rules knowledge comes from me watching other people play D&D. Or, you know, a quick Google here and there to be like, oh, this is how this rule is supposed to work.
Ty saying, fascinating. I was the complete opposite with dyslexia. I like JRPGs the most text sense before I properly could read English even. Now, this is true.
Okay. Yeah, and, you know, it's different for all of us. But yeah, no, I genuinely dislike, you know, just reading is very slow for me. And so it's probably a strong combination of dyslexia and ADHD that makes me, like, if I'm bored, then I start getting fidgety and I start like needing something else to do. And if the game is boring me and making me read, which was slowing things down, then I'm bored. I can't be here. I'm bored.
So you're big on the pacing then.
Pacing is super important. And like, you know, not just pacing, but like, why am I doing this, right? Like, player agency is one thing. There was someone just put out a really killer YouTube video talking about how did they phrase it?
I saw that. It was skill expression.
Player expression. The concept of, like, me playing a game how I want to as an expression of me as an individual, right? Like, I have never thought about it within that context before. And so, you know, that's why I love, you know, RPG-like games like Dark Souls, where it's like, oh, I get to play this how I want to play it.
Yeah.
And if a game is forcing me to play one way and I do not like it, then I don't like it even more. All right, so.
And thus your dislike for Sekiro.
And thus my dislike for Sekiro, exactly. Like, mechanically, yeah, it's all there. But it wants me to play that game in a very specific way.
That's, like, my biggest gripe, because I do QA for a lot of multiplayer games. My biggest gripe for a lot of their designs is just, like, player expression. Like, yes, people want to play strong OP characters, sure, but if they can't play it how they want in their style, so to speak, then it just becomes super, super bland.
Yeah.
How does Jack feel about BG3? How do you feel about your Baldur's Gate 3?
I haven't played it.
Oh, there you go.
Haven't played it. Probably won't. Because, I probably won't. That's not why I play Dungeons. I don't play Dungeons & Dragons for the mechanics. I play Dungeons & Dragons for the collaborative storytelling. I'm here for the prov.
There you go.
Y'all.
That's what got me. As someone who, I've talked a bit around the D&D community, and well, once you get in there, a lot of them go, okay, 5e, as far as mechanics go, is okay. But it's mostly about what you can do for the tweaking. It's the mods.
Yes. Right, that
so to hear that BG3 got so successful being based on 5e, that's what really blew my mind. And people, all, of course, biggest game, going to recommend it to everyone that they know. Mm-hmm. I was like, I don't really like the mechanics. Are you trying to just tell me about mechanics, or is there something I don't know? I'm not saying it's a bad game. I don't think it's my game.
And that's where I'm at. Is like, I'm sure everything they do is phenomenal, and enough people are having a good enough time where I'm sure it is a good game. I just don't think it's one that I'm going to necessarily enjoy. Here it is. Here's the chariot, everybody.
Dun, dun, dun. Oh, it's the guy from Elden Ring.
Yes.
Run me over in the tomb. Bastard.
The most hated boss in Elden Ring. Got his humble beginnings right here. And everybody's favorite game, Dark Souls 2. There's a little trick to this where you gotta kill the necromancers first.
was watching some of old Post's EPs and just so happened to watch one today where Jack had to be reminded that he tried and didn't remember playing Baldur's Gate 3. Gave you amnesia.
I played an early access version.
Oh, that's right, that's right.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. What?
Nope. Oh. Damn it. Don't lock on. Don't lock on. Okay, kill the skeletons, please, horse.
Oh, you played it on Stadia. That's right.
Yes. Yeah. And you know what? It was a fine play on Stadia.
Question for Jax as many. Doesn't this boss also have two ways to defeat it?
Yes. You can, I believe you can make it fall off a cliff at one point. Or you can lower the gate to kill the rider. Yeah, there's a couple ways to beat this boss. I've only ever done it this way, so that's the way I'm gonna do it. But I do believe there's a way that if you chase it to the right area, you can make it basically like fall off the map, but not in a cheese way, in a like that's how you're supposed to beat it kind of way.
Oh, Abdel Corrales, welcome to early access. Thank you.
Right, and there we go. The executioner's chariot is destroyed.
Phenomenal. What's the guy say? Simple Simon, $10. I missed 80% of the stream already, but this sounds like it's going to be a great bot. Always fun when we get past the spoofs goose and get to hear interesting stories on unrelated tangents. Well, we have multiple interests, you see.
That's like most of the streams that I am involved in.
Would you say you're a picky gamer when it comes to your choice of games?
100%. Probably annoyingly picky. Upsettingly picky.
But you're less, or you're more lenient, or I guess more willing, more eager to watch films?
Oh, of course.
With your choice, right?
Well, you know, because time.
That's primary versus games?
Well, no, it's just a time thing. It's like, you know, a bad movie is over in 2 hours, right?
There you go.
That's 2 hours of your life. A bad game, you could be locked in for 10 hours before it really starts stinking.
Oh, God. Yeah.
And then you're like, that's my time. That's my life. Right?
Right. I'm here like, you know what? Darren's getting lonely. He could use some help on the movie side of things. Whenever I see the Armored Core, Baldur's Gate 3, hundreds of hours of gameplay. It's like, I could watch so many movies.
So many movies. No, right? Like, that's the thing. There's amazing and brilliant games out there, but they're so damn long. And there's amazing and brilliant movies out there, and they're so damn long.
What was it? Hearing that Darren was doing a Batman replay. I did a Batman Arkham City replay, and I was also watching all the Batman movies. And I watched all the Batman movies, even going back to the Adam West one.
Yeah, yeah.
Before I made a sizable dent in Batman City.
Isn't that the way? Isn't that the way sometimes?
See, 130 hours of Baldur's Gate 3. I'm glad you're enjoying it. And anyone who has any good amount of time in any game, I envy you. I do.
Oh, right.
It's hard for me to justify in many games.
It's important to find things that you enjoy. And if that's where you're finding that joy, like, good on you, my friend. But, oh boy, that is a lot. All right. Where can we... did Nick beat the Skellingtons?
Skellingtons.
If he didn't beat the... Well, I guess the rider is optional. I don't know if the Skellingtons, the three Skellington bosses...
Three Skellingtons.
Maybe we can do that real quick.
What did their arena look like?
It's full of bones. It's the bone arena.
Bone zone.
Oh, he did.
George Lucas says, yeah.
Okay.
So.
Probably.
Stardew Valley 600 hours. Oh, man. Oh, God. Are you fully active in all your video games? So, like, Power Wash Simulator, surely you could listen to a podcast or something?
You know...
Or do you get full undivided attention?
A full undivided attention all the time. I honestly don't understand how people can multitask that way. It blows my mind to hear, like, even something like Power Washing Simulator, like, I am unable to pull my focus, even in, for something as simple as that. I don't have the brain for that. I need to listen to the game.
Even if it, the whole time it's just going psst.
Especially if the whole time it's only going psst.
Oh, my God. That's kind of changed the nozzle.
Yeah, I don't. I cannot fully explain it. That's just the way it be. Is I require all the attention to be given to
Alexander Mason, member for 4 months, early access. I've been playing Lies of P for what day is it? Didn't it just come out yesterday?
Good. I mean, good for you. I hear good things. I hear good things about Liza P. I wonder. I truly wonder if they're going to get the world right. Because I think that, like, many a Souls like can get the combat right.
Yep.
But can they get the world right? Can they make it feel like a mystery that you are, you know, that you are the one unraveling? Can it give you that feeling?
Yeah. It's almost like hearing, I think it's Nick that says it a lot. Oh, they got the combat. So, like, the combat's so good here. It's how I feel about shooters, where if you say the shooting feels amazing, that's almost a prerequisite. If your shooting feels bad, that's notable.
Right.
If it feels good, that's necessary.
Yes.
You know, so to go like, oh, the combat's great. It's like, cool. It won't piss me off. But will I enjoy it?
Right. So you've met the standard for the genre that you're in. Mm-hmm. Great. Yeah.
That's like you say, like, I don't hit my kids. I feed my kids.
So it's like, and great.
That doesn't make you a great dad. You just, you know, you're feeding your children.
Right. That's the thing
that, alone.
That you're supposed to do. Exactly. I'm with you 100%. And so, you know, I've seen some of the weapons that you can use in Lies of P. That looks cool. I'm hoping the combat feels good, but, like, yeah, give me that world.
Give me that world. Let me feel it. It recreates the oppressive feel of Bloodborne and the slightly diseased undertone it all pulls off in such a way I kept looking for from Software.
Ooh, okay.
I could see. Yeah, this is a, we'll see. Like, I'll probably... Is that on Game Pass today?
It's out on Game Pass.
Okay, I'll probably give it a look.
Yeah.
I'm sure I'll feel very quickly if it's for me or not.
That's all part of it. All right. We are getting there, y'all. We're just going to unlock the bonfire. We'll go beat the bone daddies. And then we might call it. It's getting close to dinner time. I should probably get back to work at some point tonight. But
yeah, we're working right now.
That's true.
We're on the clock.
That's true. We're working right now. But, you know, we got a adventurous nigh to get gotten.
Do people find a dark fantasy adaptation of Pinocchio appealing? Does that pique your interest at all?
That
the Pinocchio?
No, that makes me more likely not to play.
Oh, dang.
Right?
It gets my attention, but also at the same time, it's like, oh, Pinocchio, cool. Are you putting all the weight on that? Huh. Maybe like Winnie the Pooh. Here it comes.
Winnie the Pooh.
What's the Winnie the Pooh Blood and Honey is the first thing to come out now that it's in the public domain? Yeah. Okay. All right.
It's like I feel like you're putting too much weight on the IP here.
Right.
But it's got me curious. I want to know their take on the cricket.
The cricket's going to be the hot lady that levels you up.
Oh, you think? Dang.
Right?
That's disappointing.
That's my my assumption. I do not know.
Here it is. Sexy Jiminy and sexy Geppetto.
You know it's going to be sexy Jiminy. Hubris! Hubris!
Oh.
Nope, nope, nope. Oh, yep, Hubris got me. Ah, dang it.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
I'm a documented non-enjoyer of Souls-likes and super hard games in general, yet Bloodborne and Elden Ring grabbed me, and Lies of P just did the same.
Hmm, okay.
That's interesting. Go there.
Yeah, and it's possible. I'm not going to knock it before I try it. The thing I'm knocking is there have been plenty of people out there who I've heard like, oh, this one though, this is the one that gets it, and then you play it and you're like, no, I guess I know not to trust you.
You lied. You sit on a throne of lies.
You are the lie of P.
I knew it.
It is upon your P in which you lie.
Failed the drug test, you say. I almost feel, and maybe this is generalization, but when people went, oh, it's like Bloodborne, I go, you're not saying that simply because it's in Victorian England, are you?
Right?
You know, it's you see like three themes, you see Estus, and you go, Souls-like. I was like, Maybe that's it. Maybe I don't enjoy Souls-likes, but just the ones I did enjoy were so above, like so above and beyond.
You know, there's Doom clones, and then there's Doom,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Like,
yep.
And the difference. What's there? That's the old saying: is the difference is all the difference. Which sometimes just means that. They're forever going to be Souls likes and not Souls games.
Yeah, like TJ, you're saying the first level is literally Yharnam. It's like, but is this the game that just goes, it's Pinocchio Bloodborne, or are people going to say Lies of P, Lies of P? If you can keep your name, that in itself is worthy of something, not just anything. But that's a standard, I feel. If you can manage to maintain your name.
Ooh, like, so instead of the Souls-like, it is Lies of P.
Yeah,
it's
Pinocchio Bloodborne. No, it's Lies of P.
Yeah, yeah.
Say them in the same sentence.
Ooh, that's right. That's an incredibly good point, Frost. Because, like, when Half-Life came out, it was a Doom clone, right? But after Half-Life came out, it was Half-Life.
Oh, I remember these guys.
I remember these guys. Oh yeah, they're gonna go down easy, but then we have to deal with the hordes of skeletons, including the bone wheels. There you are, my bony friends.
Yeah, the true bosses of all Souls games. Half-Life is a Doom clone? What? Yeah, when it first came out, it was considered a Doom clone.
Yeah.
A corridor shooter.
100%. Because we didn't have the term first-person shooter yet. Everything that was a first-person shooter was a Doom clone, including Half-Life. But, to Frost's amazing point, it lived beyond that name. Crap, that's not the right healing tool. Oh, don't die, don't die. Don't die to skeletons.
Snake in the Garden, €2. Thoughts on Guillermo's Pinocchio versus Disney's? I've not seen either yet. Oh, when you say Disney, do you mean the old cartoon?
I assume you mean the old cartoon.
I was like, did they do a live action? God.
Who was the French like comedian who did a live action Pinocchio, right?
I have no clue.
Ages ago, he did a live action. All right, Skeleton Lords defeated.
First try.
Easy peasy. Y'all, there's no stopping us. There's no stopping this train.
Disney released a new Pinocchio and it stunk. Okay.
Oh, really?
I had to skip it, I guess. Like, Guillermo del Toro is during World War II, I think.
I trust Guillermo del Toro to tell an interesting story with fantastic visuals. I don't think it might not be a good story, but I will always be interested to see it.
I'm just excited because he said after his, this one or the next one, whichever one he's doing.
Yeah.
He's committing to animation for the rest of his life after that.
Oh.
Like, okay. I want to see this. Because he's one of my favorites as you said, just visuals.
Yes.
Where you go and it's like, oh, that sprang from an imagination for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Toro's Pinocchio was good, but it had awful songs. Oh, okay. That was a bit whack.
Yes, buy the thing.
Oh, God, this windmill.
The what?
We're here. This windmill.
We're here. Right? Like, oh, no. We shouldn't go too much longer. But I think we've done plenty to cement ourselves.
Yeah. You've caught up. The gap is ever closing. I feel like if you were to do one more, you could probably catch them.
I could probably do couple more, but I don't know if I can do a couple more in 6 minutes. We'll see.
No, I mean, like, if you did another stream before he comes back.
I think I'm doing it next week too. I don't believe he's
back. Oh, yeah, we're gonna catch him.
Oh yeah, yeah, we're gonna catch him. Toot sweet. We're gonna catch him pretty darn quick because I think he's not back next week, but we'll see. Is he still in the chat? Nick, are you back next week?
Not even sure what time it is in Iceland. Or
Nick.
If his sleep schedule reflects it.
Nick.
Maybe it's Marty pretending to be Nick.
That's also possible.
Yeah.
Marty, is Nick back next week?
He'll complain that your streams were longer. We would have just gotten more lost for a longer amount of time. Tuesday, September 26th, 9 a.m., says the Slack, so I don't know if that means he's going to stream.
Oh, no, I can't imagine he's going to stream on his first day back. But we'll see. Oh, no, I don't have it. Nope. Burned.
It's midnight in Ireland, so it's not too late in Iceland. Okay.
Great. Well, then, great. Let's see here. I'm trying to think of where I can go, where I can at least beat one more boss real quick.
The Rotten?
Isn't that just a sprint? That's just a sprint, so I might be able to get to the Rotten.
Flexile Sentry says the sideburns.
I already did it.
Done diddly done.
Done diddly done. Did the Flexiles already. I think there might be more up in the Bastille. I mean, I know there's more over there as far as, like, bosses and optional bosses, but I don't know if I can run to them in time. So, yeah, let's see if we can run to the Rotten real quick.
Isn't Ornstein here? He's, like, right next to the Dragon Rider, isn't he?
Oh yeah, I could go do the Dragon and Ornstein. That's a possibility, but
whatever it might miss, yeah.
Yeah, well. equip a couple poisony thingies, and then...
You've been well. I came in the place, don't you? These stones, some of them...
Yep.
Some of them.
Right, exhaust her dialogue.
Drang Lay. It's fun. I've searched every...
Just sitting out here. Like, oh, don't go in there.
Yep.
We didn't listen.
You buy stuff from her, and then you exhaust her dialogue, and then she moves to Majula.
Oh, okay. That's nice.
One of the beautiful things about this game is not only, like, Majula in general, but, like, the fact that you can fill Majula with so many NPCs.
You like a nice hub?
Yes.
What's your favorite hub of all games?
You know, it might be Majula.
Majula, iconic for sure.
Like, Majula is wonderful in that it really feels. Oh, nope. That hubris. Majula really feels homey.
Right.
If you think about, like, Firelink Shrine, or the hub area of Dark Souls 3, which I don't even remember what it's called right now.
No one does.
No, because no one does. Like, it still has that oppressive nature to it. It still feels just as oppressive as the rest of the game. Whereas Majula is beautiful and genuinely feels like a respite.
Especially because they don't stay there, you know? Like, as the game continues, all the NPCs that make it there, some of them leave or die.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, oh, God, this is worse. You're dying in my house.
Oh, hubris. That was a calculated death just because I wanted to pick up the crap on the ground, so.
Oh, God. Paul, with the $2, Majula feels like home, where I am safe. This is a waffle home.
Yes, it really, like, it... It's the hub world, and, like, you can, like, bring all the merchants there. You can bring people there and just stay in a place where you know it is safe. And that is so rare for the Souls series. And, of course, like, yeah, the beautiful, like, the sunset vistas. Oh, yeah, it's the place to be.
It's not fully safe. There's, like, those rats in the corner.
Oh, that's it does... It does have the rats in the corner.
Killed my friend. It can't be too safe, these games say. Yeah. Dark Souls 3 Hub is also called Firelink Shrine, which is kind of the name, apparently.
Fuck you, game. No, I didn't die. I just rolled off a place I did not want to roll off.
Frost, your new cold take on Armored Core was great. Well, thank you. Because I like to talk about video games, and so I don't care too much for the get good stoppage, I would call it.
The get good stoppage.
Yeah, where if you say anything about any Souls-like,
yeah,
the first place that conversation goes is like, well, how good are you? Did you beat it? Did you not? It's like, let's talk about something else. Go somewhere else.
Hmm. Fair.
Plus, I had Armored Core footage to use, so, like, yeah, why not?
I mean, there's part of me that agrees with you that, like, the get good conversation is, you know, tiresome at least. I thought there was a secret back here. No? Apparently not. The get good conversation is tiresome. I think the spirit of what get good is supposed to mean has been taken over by nefarious ne'er-do-wells.
As they do, yeah.
As they do. Where, you know, like, the idea with get good isn't like, you know, you're an idiot. At least to me, you know, it's you have to learn the game. The game is learning the game. And so, like, there's nothing you can do to beat the game except for get good at the game, right?
Right.
Oh, no. Hubris? No? Okay, no hubris.
Jeez, man.
Yeah, that was a close one.
Wow.
That was a close one. I can probably still beat this guy. We'll see. We'll see.
I mean, America Fear $2, Jack and Dark Souls, name a more iconic couple. A little power couple action, like Jay and Beyonce.
Wow. That's too much. I'm not taking that. I'm not taking that kind of responsibility.
No? All right. Yeah, but what do you say to things like you can't pause the game?
What do you mean?
You can't pause Dark Souls game.
That's true. You can't pause Dark Souls game.
Is that like a skill issue? I think that's a strange design choice, if anything. I won't agree. I won't condemn or commend, but like that is an odd choice for a single player game.
You know, the 100%. And as a parent, not having the ability to pause is ugh. I think it's very similar along with the like difficult setting conversations.
Right.
Which
right.
is like, if that is a choice by the designers of the game, then that is their choice. It's also a choice that can be criticized.
Yeah.
Like, if you prefer a game that is able to pause, like, then you get to criticize this game for its lack of pausing. Ooh. Oh, good. I win.
There you go. Yeah, I know.
We got
it's
one.
It's more a conversation about the extremes, because I also understand, like, someone not really giving a game a chance. Some games you do have to, maybe not get good, but get comfortable, get adjusted, get acclimated to
Absolutely.
What you're going for.
Yeah, yeah.
But that also brings in the assumption that it's like you didn't do everything in your power to overcome the game. It's like, okay, but what happens for those players that are really good? You know, like, at that point, their criticism, while valid, still may not be relevant anymore because their skill level is just so far gone. The way you've been playing this, I don't think the way Nick's been playing, I think, is closer to the average than the way you've been playing this so far.
Oh, 100%.
Yeah.
100%.
And so at that point, any criticism you might have is not invalid. It's just probably less relevant than whatever Nick's complaining about.
Well, it's two different pieces of criticism is all,
yeah.
Right? It's like, because we have to remember that, you know, all criticism is someone articulating their subjective opinion on a piece of art. And so Nick and I are just coming at this from two very different places.
Precisely. And I want to get to that. I want to talk about those places you guys are at instead of just going, get good, Nick, and Jack, you're sweaty. I think it goes both ways.
Ooh, like, okay.
Get away from that, and let's just talk about the games.
Sure.
Get away from this skill.
Hubris? Maybe a little hubris.
Did you play Armored Core?
I have not played Armored Core. Right. Hubris gets me again. I want to pick it up eventually, as I'm a fan of big bombastic shooters. I'm a fan of, like, you know, ultra violence. I think it will, from all I've heard about it, I think I won't enjoy it.
Right.
As you see, my play style is usually pick a route and go with it. That's how I like playing my games. I want to play a strength build. I want to play a dexterity build, right?
All right.
Everything I know about Armored Core. Oh no! Oh no! Gravity! Wow. Everything I know about Armored Core says that the point of the game is to adapt for each individual encounter, and that seems like a lot of work.
Yeah.
So I just don't think that it will be for me. I could be wrong. I think, does one of these pots have a thing in it?
No, I love this from Sideburns. Gamers are a lot like fascists. Their enemies are simultaneously both too strong, neckbeard, and too weak, scrub.
Okay. Whoa. That's
too deep.
That's deep. That's too deep for me.
Anyone better than me is a tryhard. Anyone worse than me is a noob.
Now you get it. That's the gamer spirit right there.
Mm-hmm.
decided to say, fuck it, I'm close enough to the next boss where it's like, we can probably get another boss in.
Right. One more. That's how they get you. One more.
Just one more boss. Well, and there's a couple things that I want to make sure that we do here. I know Nick didn't do them, but there's a couple things I want to make sure we do here to set us up. Oh, no. Oh, crap. This is how I died last time. Hubris! Not dead yet. There we go. So close.
What's the boss count versus the death count? We are at 16 deaths, and I'm a very negative man. I didn't do the boss count.
Ooh, someone calculate the bosses. I think we're at a pretty good boss death ratio.
Yeah, I'd say so. With the way that this is going right now. Is Jack doing a speed run to show up, Nick? It's not a speed run. It's a friendly saunter amongst
coworkers. It is a friendly recreational competition between coworkers. Nothing official about this. I saw Nick play Dark Souls 2. I wanted to play Dark Souls 2. That's all. Do I have to do this before I burn the bonfire? No, I think I can.
What level are you?
What level am I? That's a great question. Player stats, I'm level 76.
Okay.
Does anyone in chat know, do I have to talk to the ladder man before I burn down the dealie? I'll do it just in case.
Why would you have to talk to him first?
I, you know, where it's like, if it's burned down, does that scare him away? I don't know. You know, like, I don't know if that's true or not, but in my head, like, that's some bullshit that Dark Souls would do. Mm. Oh, wait, how does this work?
Ty says, can just burn it, I believe. He didn't sound too convinced.
Yeah, that's a pretty wishy-washy right there. Yeah, you know what? You are doing a really bad job of convincing me here, everyone.
Not sure. I always talk to him first for some baffling reason.
Yeah.
All right. No strong arguments here.
Yeah, no strong arguments here. I died anyway, so that's another death. We're probably, you know, like, we've been playing for 3 hours. So we're at a point where I'm getting tired and hungry. But now that I've said we're going to do another boss, we should probably do another boss.
Is this modded? It doesn't look as diarrhea-y as usual.
This is not modded. Oh, no. Oh, my God.
Oh,
that wasn't hubris. That was just getting
murder.
Getting wrecked. That was 100% getting wrecked. And no, this is unmodded. This is just how it comes. Holy crap, did they beat the shit out of me. Was that
Trade out the box.
All right. First of all, deal with you two. Then you, sir, come to me. Come to me, sir. Thank you. I would like to talk to you about our Lord and Savior, my club.
My big club.
My big club. I should use an effigy because I'm running very low on health. There we go. Shirtless man power go! I feel like I want to talk to him first. I don't know if we need to or not, but I feel like I want to. Just in case. No one in chat has been able to give me has made me feel comfortable. Nope. Stop it.
Nick and Jack can compete over Dark Souls 3 next. Is Dark Souls 3 shorter?
Yes? No? Question mark?
It's a lot more straightforward, that's for sure.
That's for sure.
Yeah, what is the club name? You never named your club.
Are we supposed to name our club?
You don't name your weaponry.
Apparently not.
Well, unnamed.
And this is unnamed.
It's unnamed club. Nick already did Dark Souls 3, then it'll be even.
Oh, how do we...
Earl says, Ladderman only moves after killing the boss or talking to him.
Okay. So I can burn... Well, and I guess, like, to me, I guess what I've decided is it doesn't really matter. Because I need to get up there to move a thing anyway.
Right.
So.
Yeah. A couple names for your club. You got Thwacker.
The Thwacker!
Babe the Ruthless. I like Thunder Thwacker.
I like the Thwacker. I don't need to use it efficiently. I just need to use it in general. All right. We have to... Wait.
Jack the Whacker Packard.
Easier.
Jim is at the Clubber Lane.
I'm here for it.
So what is your objective currently?
Okay, my first objective is to knock these two fuckers off of their posts so they don't gank me when I walk up this ladder.
Right.
Because that's what happened last time. That's how I died last time. And I believe there is a lever up here somewhere that I need to pull. Oop, dog. Dog bark at things. I believe there's a lever up here that I need to pull in order to open a gate.
All right. Wow, Jack is an expert actually using range. I always keep a bow in the back pocket.
Oh, you gotta. You gotta keep a bow in the back pocket. You just gotta. Where is... Chatty chat, where's the lever to open up that gate? Did I miss it? Chatty chat. Oh, this is me asking for help. I need help.
Isn't it on the other side?
Down the other side.
That's funny. Nick got too much help. We're out here high and dry. Here.
Right? I just need a tiny bit of help. There's this gate right here that I need to open, and right. I don't know how to open it. Just a wee bit of help.
Isaac, there, that's the ladder right there. It's by the gears inside.
That doesn't help.
Those gears, no?
I think I've been there.
You will explore the windmill and you will like it.
I don't. I won't.
There's a lever higher, I think. Got it. Oh, no, I can't say the lever.
It can't be a level higher because a level higher is...
Heaven.
Is, Oh, no, it was a level lower.
Oh, you lied, Paul. Get good, Jack, says Sideburns.
I will not. I refuse. I refuse to get good. It was a level lower is where it was. Okay. So now that that is up, I should be able to go up here, talk to Ladderman. Nope, 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 nope. That wasn't it. Damn it. Help, chat! Why won't you help?
Isaac, specifically, you. Help. Get through the bystander effect.
It's okay to Google it. Do I have to go down even further? What's down here? My imminent death?
Oh.
No, no death. No death yet.
Ross will become the Dark Souls 2 expert just from watching all these people play it. Honestly, probably not. After this, though, it has... I'm starting to get the itch Jack was talking about.
or one person starts playing it, and the rest of you get infected.
You know, it's like, oh, well, I could play it. I could play it.
What's need help with? Yeah, what do you need specifically?
See, this gate right here that gets me out to this balcony is closed, and I need to know how to open that gate.
Yeah, there you go.
And up here, I didn't see any levers. I didn't see anything to pull. All
right.
There's nothing to pull up here. And over here is the boss. I know that. The boss is that way.
Rafi says you need to go up the ladder.
Okay, right. I'm up the ladder.
I'm realizing how difficult it is to describe a room in this place.
Right? I'm up the ladder.
Okay, where is he?
There you can go in the room at your left once up.
Okay.
You went up the ladder and then there's a room on your left.
All right, I'm... Well, the room on... There is a room on my left that... there's stuff over here. There's like a fire lady over here.
Right, I'm at right, sorry. Yeah.
I'm at right. Okay. What's okay, right. Go down. Oh wait, go down to the blender room? Oh okay, I know what the blender room is. Now you're speaking my language.
What's the blender room?
It's you'll see in a second. It's a room with a blender. Like, that's it.
Rafi says you were there.
Oh, okay. Hold on.
Blender room, where they make delicious smoothies.
Yeah. Okay.
Oh.
See, the blender room.
Ah.
Yeah. Okay, I'm in the blender room.
But Nick couldn't get across. I didn't know you could just jump that.
Frost, you can do whatever you want.
Oh.
Okay, so now go to the place with all the poison pots. Well, first of all, hopefully that was a joke, because like everything in this goddamn place is a poison pot.
Right. Go on and you will find the path. You just keep going.
Okay.
There's a chest here. I think that's a naughty chest.
That is a naughty chest.
Why are we opening it then?
Because you still get a prize.
Oh.
if it's a naughty chest, you can just roll away from it.
Oh.
And then once the naughtiness goes away, you still get a prize.
Okay. Wait, what's this one?
All right, over here. Is this where we want to go? This doesn't feel... I think Pate's over here. Pate is usually over here, right? No? All right. Well, that door could not open. Fair. Oh, maybe I didn't unlock... I didn't move Pate forward. Shit. Okay. Y'all, I'm not seeing no shit.
Yes.
Oh, wait, there's some shit. Oh no! Am I going to die because of my shit? Possibly.
Yeah, where's the yellow paint when you need it? Exactly.
I think we did it, everyone.
We got it. Okay.
I think we got it.
Well, those weird wall lever things. All right.
All right. You die, please.
Or kill him. Sorry, even reading the wiki, I can't make heads or tails of this. Everyone's got like a big map. It's like, oh, God.
No, and I don't blame you. It is very difficult. But we are here now. I thought...
There we go.
I thought the lever was something we flicked on this side. It was actually something we flicked on the other side to open up. So now let's talk to the letterman.
Shush. You agent.
Oh. You're a fugitive. I don't remember you.
No, you wouldn't. Nick didn't talk to him. But the Ladderman is a vendor in general. He builds this ladder, which is incredibly useless. This ladder will do no good for anyone.
What?
He builds you a ladder on the side of the tower.
All right.
It does nobody any good. Oh, no, well, I think it gives you like a prize.
You still missed the real lever, apparently.
Oh, well. Whatever, I'll just go back to the bonfire. All right. Oh, yes, and he sells the club that I want. Ooh, baby.
Ooh, the Uber club.
The club.
Right.
The reinforced club. Oh, yeah, this is great.
Like chaos is a ladder.
Okay, so, and if you talk to him, he tells you about the secret to this area, which is burning the windmill. If you burn the windmill, the poison leaves the area. All right. Oh, we're doing it, everybody. This is gaming. Boom. We got that. We are now ready for one more boss. I think. Oh, I didn't. They're right. I didn't open it up. That's fine.
Oh.
No, that's
oh,
okay.
There's the lever.
Yeah,
right,
it's right
there.
Here.
Oh, no.
It's right here. It's fine.
What?
Everything's
yeah,
fine.
No, this pod racing is.
Now this.
Now we.
All right. So
burn
now
it all down.
We light the torch. Burn it all down.
Oh yeah. If Nick never talked to him and he burned the windmill, doesn't that mean you didn't have to? So.
But Nick never talked to him, and I wanted to talk to him because the real secret is that if you talk to him, he moves to Majula. I don't think he moves to Majula if you don't talk to him.
Oh.
I believe you have to talk to him first, then he moves to Majula, and he can set up ladders to get down the pit.
Oh, that's how you're supposed to get down there.
So
okay.
That you don't, so that you don't have to like just fall down and be a dickhead.
Yeah, that's me.
Yeah,
I dickheaded my way down.
Oh, it took me like 3 or 4 playthroughs to figure that one out. but if he can build the ladders in Majula, then you can just walk down the pit, which is great. Mm-hmm. Okay. So now, run past you. Nope, I'm running past you. You can't beat me. I'm running past you.
Nick tried dropping down that a few times. Yeah, he dickheaded it too. We did have the cat ring though. So.
Yeah. We dickheaded it. You know, we all do it. It's not a condemnation.
I tried to speed run it. I boosted my vitality. I got the ring. That's all I did. I was just grinding because I was like, there's something good down here. I bet late game weapons now.
Oh, yeah.
There's nothing juicier than getting a late game weapon as early as possible.
Ooh, yeah. Absolutely.
But no. There's just more pain and suffering down there.
Yeah, it was like the worst things were down there. Mm-hmm. Right. And then we go over here, pick this up, kill you.
Yep, the pit in Majula tricks you into leveling HP. Yeah, I had to start a different character.
Oh, really? All right, let's go see if we can beat this boss. This should be relatively simple, but you never know. I died, what, like 3-4 times to the Lost Center?
Yep, in the light.
I think I said I was gonna level stamina, and I don't know if I did.
What is your club skill on strength?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, and all I've been doing is leveling strength and everything else.
Ooh, nope, nope. Okay, okay. How about heal? How about heal? Nope. Oh, crap.
Hubris. Haven't died yet.
Oh, okay, got her. Nice.
Okay. I thought it was going to get me one more time.
First try. And first our topical try. Opinions on Anaconda. The franchise? The movie? Wait, who's he?
Yeah, he's. I ran past him to get to the boss. And
was it, where'd he come from? This just, guy.
Hey, I wanted to fight you too.
I'm the real boss.
Nope, bye.
Now you fight me, Jeremy.
I didn't actually expect you to still be here by the time I got back. You mean streaming? Or yeah. in the thing? Yeah, you know, I checked out. I wanted to make sure we could do a little bit longer of a stream just because of all the crap I've been giving Nick, I really wanted to hammer home like how quickly you can get through most of this game.
Yeah, you're ruining the averages of howlongtobeat.com.
Yeah. No, it's tragic. It's fine. Oh, the Iron Keep sucks. This is the worst. This is the part where I will die the most. I hate this is the second worst run back.
Second worst. What's the first?
To the chariot. Usually the run back to the chariot is the worst. I found, actually just on my last playthrough, I found the way to make that run back incredibly bearable.
Okay.
Which is, if you go to a certain place, it tricks the enemies into falling off the bridge. So I found a way to cheese it.
Perfect. Let's see here. I think you kind of caught up. Like, yeah, you'd have to beat the boss, obviously, but I think you're, like, right on the last episode.
No, because this is the flame castle. So, like, we have, like, the knight with the fire belly and the big devil.
Oh, that's right.
So, like, I got to do that still. I still have to beat the poison queen, I think.
Yeah, you didn't get was the rotten optional?
The rotten is. I still have to do the rotten still. So there's quite a bit I have to do. But my guess is by the end of next stream, we will be caught up to Nick.
That's what happens when you go to Iceland, man.
Yeah.
And Simple Simon with the $10. If it's in an effort to troll Nick, stream as long as you want. Oh, and Dower Dodger Esquire with a big old $99.99.
Holy crap, Dower Dodger.
DS2 Efficiency Appreciation Dono. Thanks, Jack.
Okay, now I have to stream this all the time. If that's the kind of scratch we're going to be making. Holy moly, that's a whole lot.
It's paying off. All those hours of Dark Souls.
Oh, man. Well, we appreciate that support.
You do have to catch up in deaths, because right now you're just at 18?
18 deaths.
18
Boom.
Deaths.
Boom. Yeah. So, yeah, now all we need to concentrate on is basically getting souls, so I can level up my other weapon, my preferred weapon, this guy, which is... Oh, actually already more powerful than my current weapon.
Oh, you're at the Iron Keep. That's a farming spot, isn't it?
I don't know.
Well, that's what some people say, because they get like 700 souls of pop or something.
Yeah, there's still a few things. Like, we still need to beat the spider. We still need to beat the rotten. We need to beat quail egg poison. So... Jack, oh yeah, I could die like 50 times, like, right now. But we are on our way, everybody.
Yeah.
So thanks. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for Nick for taking a work vacation so I can have an excuse to play more Dark Souls 2. Thanks for Frost for watching literally the same game played at the same spot.
It's not the same game, Jack. This is a different game entirely now.
Good. Good, good. All right.
Yeah. as far as here. Today is Tuesday. I believe that's all the streams for today. Tomorrow you're going to get your post ZPs and your breakouts, and everything else should be normal.
Everything else should be normal. Thursdays, I don't know if I'm going to make it to Zelda stream because we streamed today. Saturday, New Adventures Night for everybody. So exciting for that. And do you have a new Stuff of Legend or Cold Take coming out soon?
The new Stuff of Legends that came out for everybody yesterday. That's the World of Warcraft Funeral Crashers.
Yes.
Enjoy that. As far as early access, we got a new Cold Take, and that is on the Get Good. As Get Gooding. It's a talk, it's a conversation, you know? You can still keep saying Get Good, Get Filtered, whatever you like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, that should do it for us. And then Friday, I keep saying Spy Fox. Sly Cooper. With Amy and myself. Saturday, Myth Force with myself and Will. And then on Sunday, newly released, all the lovely scheduled stuff that you guys know and love. Thank you all for coming.
Yeah, thanks for coming. And we'll see you later. Bye, everyone. Oh, no, my mouse is still attached to Dark Souls. Sorry. Sorry for making everyone vomit just then. Bye. Oh, why is my bye so small? Hey, there we go.
What? Oh.
It was small and in the corner.
It's hiding, a shy bye.
We'll make it like one of those DVD screensavers. Bink.
Oh, and then it hits the corner.
Bink.
I have an idea.
And right when it hits the corner,